Cartman, dude, what's wrong?
Nothing. Just leave me alone, okay?
Something's going on.
That essay that Garrison assigned us.
What I want to be when I grow up?
I want to be a NASCAR driver, okay?
Cartman, if you want to drive NASCAR when you grow up, you can.
Oh, right. You really think someone like this can ever become an awesome, famous NASCAR driver?
Aw. Cartman, you can change things about yourself.
Come on, you guys. I have to face facts. I'm not poor and stupid enough to do NASCAR, and I never will be.
Dude, I don't think just poor and stupid people like NASCAR.
Hey, Kitty!
Huh?
You love NASCAR, huh? You see, I told you guys, what's the use? It's hopeless!
Cartman, you are poor and you are stupid.
I know you're trying to make me feel better, Kyle.
Dude, you are so retarded.
Thanks, Dan, but even if I was, I'd still be too rich.
How are you rich? Your mom pays for everything!
You guys really think I could do this, don't you?
Maybe I can make myself believe it, too. Thanks, you guys. Butters.
Hey, Eric.
The guys have been talking to me and, well, they've got me pretty pumped up. I'm about to do something big and I'm psyched. Can you get psyched? You gonna get psyched up?
I'm really psyched. Yeah, let's do this, all right? Yeah.
I'm gonna become a NASCAR driver, Butters.
NASCAR?
I know. I'm not poor and stupid enough. I want you to take all my money. $58.32. Don't tell me where you spend it and don't ever let me have it back. From this moment on, I am poor. Like Kenny. I'm gonna get as poor and stupid as I possibly can.
Boy, I'll tell you what, it is raining cats and dogs outside. Mostly cats.
Hey, Eric!
Did you give away all my money?
Yep, you don't have a penny left. Look, how come you're hanging upside down?
I need to get stupid, Butters. I'm getting all the blood to rush to my head and watching a marathon of 2.5 men.
Hey, that's a hot girl over there.
Sure, she's hot. She's wearing a sweater.
Feel stupid yet?
Not yet.
To stop feminine itching and relieve vaginal odors.
Ah, goddammit, another Vagisil commercial?
All those ladies had stinky vaginas?
In some cases, Vagisil can lead to short-term memory loss.
In some cases, Vagisil can lead to short-term memory loss. We need Vagisil. Vagisil maximum strength, Vagisil wash, Vagisil medicated wax. Just keep a lookout, I'll try it here. Look that way, make sure the cashier doesn't see me. Is there anybody coming?
No, you're good.
Kim?
Little boy, what are you doing?
Oh my god, Butters. I feel kind of stupid.
Really?
Yes! I'm feeling totally stupid right now. Grab what you can and let's get out of here. I'm ready.
We are just seconds away from the start of the Denver 300!
Your wife is on the phone and she just got raped!
Oh my god!
Sweet, nice work, Butters. I'm totally poor and stupid. I'm ready for NASCAR. Let's go, NASCAR! I'm not moving, Butters.
I think you gotta push the gas pedal.
Let's go, NASCAR! All the effort I put in, I still wasn't poor and stupid enough to win.
Erica, you were as poor and stupid as you could be.
Those people are way more poor and stupid than I'll ever be.
All right, Eric, we got the x-rays back. He has 2 fractured ribs, a broken femur, torn ligaments in both knees, and a level 2 concussion. He also appears to be developing 3 small vaginas in his stomach.
Just pull the plug on me, doctor. I don't want to live like this.
You aren't on life support. Pulling a plug wouldn't do anything. Sneaking onto a NASCAR racetrack and hijacking a car for a joyride? That has got to be the stupidest thing I've ever heard of a kid doing.
Did you hear that, Eric? You are really stupid.
Get me my coat, Butters. We're gonna try this thing again. Check it out. I thought I could just give all my money away and be poor as your family. What do poor people do? Buy things even though they don't have money by going out and purchasing things that are 0% down and no payments for 2 years. Kenny, I'm just trying to get good at NASCAR. I've had to become poor all on my own, you know? I wasn't born with a plastic spoon in my mouth.
What?
Look, Kenny, we both love NASCAR and we're both poor as shit.
Eric Cartman, I'm the founder and CEO of Vagisil.
Uh-oh.
Young man, your NASCAR stunt has brought a lot of attention to Vagisil, and honestly, our sales are up and women are finally realizing that their feminine odor can be treated. Vagisil has a little present for you.
Kenny.
So what's your guy's take on the track here? Any concerns?
Well, I think it's a fine track. You know, the techs have done a really good job.
Yeah, we like the track, yep. So we're going to drive straight and then we're going to be turning to the left.
They're saying hot weather tomorrow.
Of course, anytime you're dealing with high humidity and temperatures.
Jump inside your bike fluid and get your brake working so you can stop sometimes.
Excuse me, who is this kid? Is he even a driver?
You bring it on, Earnhardt. You scared the competition.
You seemed really stupid, Eric.
Thanks, B-Buds. I really think I can hold my own against these guys.
Lots of speculation and interest in the Vagisil car, driven by Eric Cartman.
Vagisil is very excited to be part of the NASCAR phenomenon, Chris. You know, I first created Vagisil to try and help my wife, Patty. Wherever Patty goes, her smile lights up the room. Her vagina, on the other hand, clears the room and makes it uninhabitable for weeks. We want women to know that Vagisil is effective, safe for use every day. Every day. Every day. And available nationwide.
Start your engines!
All right, start your engine. What's that mean?
Is he stupid or what?
Yeah, he's a champion, all right.
I'm gonna press the gas pedal and I'm gonna go forward.
This is just the pace lap. You don't go full speed yet.
Yeah, just the pace lap. I'm gonna hit the brake.
The fuck are you doing?
You ain't half as dumb as me.
Oh, son of a bitch!
Careful up here, about 100 yards there. There's a wet car on the right side.
Oh, yeah, man. Danica Patrick tried to get in my way. That pisses me off. Oop, I'm coming up on that turn thing again. I got to stare left.
Looks like you're going to win, Mr. Hamill.
This is such a great day for Vagisil, Chris. Feminine odor must be treated diligently, very diligently, Patty.
Let me talk to her. Patty? Patty, what are you doing?
You're acting irrationally.
You know how you get when you don't use your Vagisil. There should be some in your purse, my muse.
I deserve it. I thought I could just waltz onto a racetrack and do what these people do. The truth is, I'm just too smart. And with how smart I am, I'll always be successful and therefore have money. It's time for me to give it up. All right, Butters, give me back my money.
But you said I had to be spent on the...
God damn it, Butters, you better have it! The city isn't what it used to be. Everything went to crap. Bad economy made things worse. Then a black man was elected president. He was supposed to change things. He didn't. Dark times. The city needs protection. I am the hero this town needs. The king. A woman being raped. This is what our city has been reduced to. Get out of here! Get to safety!
Lisa! Come here!
Another woman saved from rape. But how many more rapists are out there? You guys hear that another rape victim got saved by a superhero last night? They say it was the Coon.
Who is the Coon?
It's what everyone must be asking themselves. Somebody is dressing up at night and taking the law into their own hands.
Yeah, and dressing up and running around at night is faggy anyway.
Fuck you!
Dude, what?
He's not a fag!
Why do you care?
Oh. I'm just... Is he a hero or a menace? While we can all admit that the Coon is obviously really cool, why does he sacrifice himself every night to rid our streets of crime? What we all need now... Clyde, could you wake up, please? This is important. I believe that tonight the Coon is going to be on the roof of Walgreens. I know I'll be there with my camera. I'm sure many of you will, too.
Sometimes it seems the more criminals I try to stop, the more just come out of the back alleys and dilapidated bars.
Who the hell are you?
I'm an angel keeping watch over the city at night. I am Mysterion. My identity must remain a secret. You cannot know. Yeah, well, you cannot know my true identity either.
You don't care about stopping crime. You're just doing this because you hate me, Kyle.
Kyle hates Eric Cartman. Are you saying you're Eric Cartman?
No, I'm saying that.
I cannot stand here and make idle conversation any longer.
No! Dude, I'm seriously, you're being a copycat. I'll sue you. I try to do good stuff and nobody even notices.
Tonight, an incredible story.
But who exactly is Mysterion?
What?
Well, I think he's kind of a symbol for the town, you know? A symbol that everyone who's sick of crime can rally behind. If you have any idea about the true identity of Mysterion, please call the 9 News hotline.
Ah,
Mysterion, thank God you've come.
There's some graffiti on the bridge again. And the guy at the movie theater is harassing Mexicans again.
Thank you. Thank you for all your help.
I know it's you, Cal. Just stop.
I don't have time for this.
Fireworks are illegal in Colorado, you asshole! So, guys, any of you do anything interesting last night? Nobody was playing with any fireworks? Now, come on, which one of you guys is it?
How are you so sure Mysterion is a boy?
Fucking bitch.
Look what the cat dragged in.
Come out where I can see you.
You come to put a stop to me again.
I didn't call you to fight, Chaos. I came to see if you know Mysterion's identity.
Now, General Disarray!
Knock it off!
Yeah, we beat him, General Disarray!
Listen to me! I want to help you get rid of Mysterion! Because Mysterion is trying to... No, fucker, that fucking hurt! Because Mysterion is trying to say he's the hero this town needs. But that's my job.
I will show you what we know about Mysterion's identity. This way! We will now show you our secret headquarters of doom. Using our photos, we are trying to pinpoint Mysterion's identity. Based on his body type, it's gotta be someone like Stan or Kyle.
All right, look, Chaos. Just set up a video camera. I know how we can put an end to Mysterion once and for all.
2 days ago, an evil unknown terrorist threatened major consequences if Mysterion does not reveal his identity.
Mark my words, South Park. Your precious hero is now your undoing. If Mysterion does not unmask himself publicly by Wednesday night, I am going to blow up a hospital. Jesus Christ!
Since the threat was issued, there's been no sign of Mysterion.
But you really want to blow up a hospital?
Sometimes blowing up hospitals is for the greater good, Chaos. All right, Chaos. I'm gonna get the triggers for these things at Ace Hardware.
Oh, geez, General Disarray. This is a lot more than I ever really intended. Ha! I'm a Mysterion!
Why are you doing this?
Ow.
He's dead.
Wait! Look!
Oh my God, look everyone, it's the king! The king will now help you!
Oh jeez, I think I broke a tooth!
That was great teamwork, Mysterion. South Park is safe. Until next time. Won't be long before the next villain comes along and threatens violence unless you take off your mask.
Citizens, tonight has shown me I have no choice but to unmask myself. As long as my identity is a mystery, this will just happen again and again. It has to end. I will show my face.
I knew it was you! Remember, I even said it before!
Well, I'm sorry, but you're under arrest. Take the kid to jail.
With Mysterion out of the way, the king can finally go back to keeping the city safe. Every town needs a king.
I slept with Vanessa last night!
Oh my God, dude, this is so awesome!
You took my girl, and you took my job!
Wrestling is awesome!
Tomorrow we are signing up for wrestling class!
The fuck is this?
Alright, so did everyone settle on their wrestling names?
I did. I'm the Red Russian. I come from Russia to crush your puny capitalist head!
Let's get some volunteers. Why don't you come over here, young man? What's your name?
The Red Russian.
Just go ahead and get on your hands and knees.
Okay.
Here we go.
The fuck is this? Dude! The fuck are you doing?
That's not wrestling, dude. That's fucking gay.
How stupid are you? Real wrestling, boys, is this.
Well, this is fucking lame, dude. Let's get the hell out of here, guys.
All right, let's start wrestling. You slept with my girlfriend, Hammerclaw.
Hey, now hold on. I am stopping the fight.
I served my country. I fought for 2 years in Vietnam.
That kid was in Nam?
You will have to forfeit the fight, Red Russian. You cannot fight until your test results come back.
I might have to wait for my hepatitis test, but in the meantime, I have brought my comrade from Mexico to wrestle against you.
El Pollo Loco!
What are you doing here, El Pollo Loco?
Your girlfriend doesn't even like you, Stan the Man. She likes me.
Let me tell you something. I want to be with Juggernaut now.
If you love Juggernaut, Irene, then tell him what you did 2 years ago. How you killed his child.
I was pregnant with your child and I aborted it.
Do you know what it's like to have an abortion at 7 years old?
I've had so many abortions. I just got addicted to them.
I'm not in love with you. I'm in love with abortions, don't you understand?
Only a country like yours can breed men of such discontent, Rad Russian. But you don't know what real pain is. Abandoned when I was 4 years old by my parents. Left to die in a cold and dark sewage tunnel.
Jeez, I didn't know his parents did that.
You guys, listen to this. It's amazing. The WWE is delighted to inform you that it will be sending a talent scout to view your wrestling event this Saturday, the 24th.
This is our shot at making it into the WWE.
Guys, listen. We seriously have to focus here. We've got to step it up and work it like never before.
I left my wife today. I ran away from my responsibilities, just like I always do. And I, again, am alone.
I'll fight anytime, anywhere!
He don't run from fights, just from responsibilities.
Juggernaut is my long-lost brother, and yet Congo saved my life in Nam.
It's El Pollo Loco!
Places, everyone!
Welcome to this performance of Wrestling Takedown Federation.
No, Irene, please! Just this once! Do not abort this baby!
I think maybe I'll have another abortion right here, right now.
A baby you aborted many years ago survived! And he's here now!
Mother! Why did you abort me? Why?
You! Get back in the trash can where you belong!
Excuse me. I'm sorry, I'm afraid this area is off limits.
Hey! Whoa! The fuck is this?
Only one shot. Maximum damage. Now.
For wrestling!
So you see, I have nothing left. Nothing!
Sir, that was one of the finest wrestling performances I have ever seen. I promise to make you our leading act. Come, I want to get you in rehearsals right away.
Hey, what about us? Our show?
Sorry, boys. You are decent wrestlers, but lack the raw wrestling talent this man has.
It's all your fault, Kyle. You screwed up the second act.
The hell's this?
Screw this. This is just stupid.
Oh, don't start with me, Kitty.
Mike!
Kitty.
Oh, hey, Kyle. Hang on a sec. I just wanted to make sure you've heard the fantastic news. There's a new Terrence and Phillip mobile game, and it's so amazing and incredibly fun. It's free. You should download it to your phone right now.
Cool. Thanks, Jimmy. Well, I'll check it out.
You betcha, pal.
The Terrence and Phillip mobile game. Can you collect all the Canadian coins? You've collected 10 Canadian coins. With Canada coins, you can buy stuff and help Terrence and Phillip rebuild Canada. Buy them in bulk. You bought 200 Canadian coins for 49 cents. Now use that Canada to help rebuild Canada.
Yay!
It's stupid, and now I paid 49 cents for it.
I played that thing. It's fucking dumb. I ended up paying like $5.
What's the big idea, making a mobile game without our approval?
We thought you would be pleased with the quality of the mobile game.
All you do is collect and spend Canada. If you charge 40 cents here and 50 cents there, then it's not free.
I see through the charade.
All right, fuck it. You might as well know everything. 4 years, the concept behind gaming was simple. Explore, collect, spend, improve. But whereas those just used the concept of XP, we've introduced the idea of micro-paying with money. Money, 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 money.
It's what everyone is doing, and it's all just a lot of harmless fun.
Can you explain to us how you managed to spend $489 on a mobile app?
I didn't realize I spent that much.
Stan, just because I make a good living with my music doesn't mean you can go blow it all on Canada.
Entice the player with a simple game loop. Use lots of flashing cha-chings and compliments to make the player feel good about themselves. Offer the players a way to spend real currency for your fake currency,
so they'll forget they're spending money. Can't the game hidden inside the charade just at least be fun?
If the game was too fun, then there would be no reason to micropay in order to make it more fun. What's this?
Your checks, of course, for 10 million American dollars.
So this is... everyone is doing this?
Everyone is doing it!
Well, I guess if everyone's just paying 40 cents at a time, it can't be that bad.
Oh, hey, guys.
You missed school today? Did you play the Terrence and Philip freemium game all day?
Well, yeah, I was sick in bed. What else was I gonna do?
How much money did you micropay today, Stan?
I bought like $10 worth of Canada. But check it out, I unlocked a stadium in Toronto.
You spent $10 and 8 hours to unlock a stadium.
You guys, is it that much dumber than video games you play?
Yes.
Like Jimmy said, it's a cool way to zone out.
Jimmy told you about this game? What? Hey, Jimmy, can we talk? You need to stop recommending that app to people.
I just think it's a fabulous app, that's all.
What happens on level 2 after you get the Ontario Nugget?
All right. I never played it.
You just push it on other people?
They pay me too.
Who, Jimmy? Who pays you?
New hospitals, new neighborhoods, all funded by one freemium game.
We really aren't comfortable with this freemium thing.
It seems dishonest, and we have a brand to protect. But just look at all the things we're getting to build.
We're just worried that some people will abuse the game and start spending more money than they can afford.
Well, we certainly wouldn't want that. How about we take some of the billions of dollars we are making and we start a campaign to teach everyone to play the game in moderation?
Do you really think that would help?
The alcohol industry does it all the time.
I want you to see this. There you go. That's your grandpa. He sits at that slot machine and mindlessly drains money away a little bit at a time. Sound familiar? What is the joy that this stuff possibly brings you? You two have demons you're trying to compensate for.
You're having a glass of wine.
I'm having 6. It's called a tasting and it's classy.
I just like playing it, but I don't have to. I'll prove it.
Yeah, and if he stops, I'll stop.
If you two stop, then we won't have a problem anymore. Earthy, bold, hint of cherry aftertones.
How do you get people addicted to crack? You give it away for free. You give away a little taste, and then some people can't stop themselves.
And now Stan is so consumed by the shit you've been pushing that he can't even see through it. I needed the money, all right?
I downloaded Yum Yum Sparkly Gym Forest because it was free. Then I made my first in-app purchase. Before I knew it, I had spent my allowance, then my birthday money. I lost my crutches!
You have your crutches.
It's a figure of speech with crippled people.
That makes sense.
Why do you think freemium games send you those text notifications when you haven't played in a while? They know exactly what they're doing.
Hey, buddy. Come on, guy. We've just given you 5,000 Canadian coins. Enjoy your Canada.
Free?
You said you stopped buying Canada. $26,000? Do you know how many songs I have to write to make back that much money?
One.
You need to realize that you have something in your brain that you somehow inherited from your grandpa that makes you act this way, okay?
I don't know how you can say that when you're standing here chugging beer.
I'm sampling a flight of gluten-free German lagers with a French wine pairing.
Okay, I need help. I know the game is stupid, and it actually isn't even fun anymore. Phyllis, could I have a minute with Stan, please? I should have never told you the game was fantastic. I know this stuff is hard to understand. I'm an addict, too. But I got help. What all the addiction programs say is true. You gotta reach out to a higher power, Stan.
You son of a bitch! You paid pushers to get addicts hooked on our freemium game? You didn't build a mobile game! You built an addiction machine!
All right, you've seen through the charade again. Let me explain how freemium games really work.
It's all about finding the heaviest users and extracting the most amount of cash from them.
But then all our profits come from people with problems.
Think about all the money. Here, have a bump of coke.
Okay, but we still won't stand for this.
Here is a fact. 80% of alcohol sales are paid for by alcoholics.
We're building a new Canada with micropayments from addicts. They don't care that 10% are gonna get addicted. They're counting on it. Every button they click, we get feedback on how to shove this shit right down their throats.
Oh, I'm much worse than the devil.
the Canadian devil! Ha 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 ha!
I guess I have something inside me that I can't control. Please, help show me the way.
You have summoned the Prince of Temptation.
I have addiction demons and I don't understand them.
So you've got dopamine, right? That's the chemical that gets released in your brain whenever you do something pleasurable. But because humans have progressed and now have access to all the shit they want whenever they want it, it's easy for them to overdo and have dopamine problems. So like if you keep doing something too much, eventually there's, a dopamine fuck up, right? And you're kind of screwed up for life.
So what does that mean? I can get addicted to everything so I can't enjoy anything?
So let's talk about genetics now. You still have time?
Yeah, no, this is great.
So basically, the genes you got from your dad make you more likely to have trouble with dopamine regulation, and that's why you need to kind of watch out for addictive stuff.
But why do companies have to put so many addictive things out there?
Well, you know, everyone has their justification and thinks what they're doing is okay.
Hey, buddy, where'd you go?
What's this?
That's what I've been addicted to.
What, you just collect coins? But this is just blatant Skinner box manipulation. Who put this out?
Canada?
He's always doing this shit! I tell him, temptation has to be nuanced. I'm gonna need to borrow your soul real quick, kid. Is that alright?
Okay.
Stan, where are you going?
Told you, kid's got demons. I don't do that.
When the prince signed the agreement to make a freemium game, he apparently made a deal with the Canadian devil. This is a sad day for Canada and their fall to wealth.
Once again, you lack any sense of nuance.
You're no match for Canadian Satan! Watch it, yeah! Certainly a shocking turn of events here, as the actual devil has now appeared and seems to be fighting the Canadian devil.
Enough, Beelzebub!
Hey, dude.
Hey. Kid.
What are you gaywads doing?
We're playing board games, so that Grandpa avoids the casino and I avoid freemium apps.
Tell you what, I'll join you. Board games go good with a glass of wine.
That's not a glass, that's a trophy.
It's called a Wine Zinfandel sipping sprint, and it's competitive.
Your turn, Grandpa. If you roll a 5 or 6, you can kill these zombies.
You guys want to put some money on it?
You guys! Oh my God, you guys! Seriously, you guys, guess what? You know Pete Melman? He crapped his pants today during social studies.
How do you know?
It's all over Eavesdropper. It's a website about all the students in the school. Eavesdropper got a hold of the phone call from the nurse to Pete Melman's mom.
Hello, Mrs. Melman. I'm afraid your son has had a little accident. Oh, no. What is it?
Turn
is he
it
okay?
Up.
He went number 2 during class. I'm afraid he's going to need a new pair of pants and underwear.
So what do we call Pete Melman when we see him? I was thinking Poopy Pants Pete.
Eric Cartman? Report to the principal's office immediately.
Oh, Jesus, what now?
A student here at South Park Elementary had an accident in the classroom. It has been almost 1 year since Corey Duran defecated in his pants here at school. Now, you remember what happened to him?
Yeah, he killed himself.
The ridicule and the torment from other students spearheaded by you made him feel there was no other way out.
You're asking me to simply ignore a kid who shit in his pants in front of everyone so he can have a normal life?
We are hoping that if you don't fan the flames, Eric, the other students might forget about it.
The truth is, he was dead the second he crapped his pants.
This school cannot have another suicide on its hands. If Pete Melman does not kill himself, we will make it very worth your while.
Make it worth my while how?
Hey, Jenny. Sup? So, what you doing for lunch?
My mom packed me the best stuff. She even baked cupcakes.
I don't like you.
I'm sorry. I wasted your time.
Look, I'm sorry. That was mean. I'd love to try one of your mom's cupcakes.
Males are mammals.
Mr. Garrison, can I please be excused?
What's the matter?
I just need to go to the restroom.
Well, okay.
Well, just give it a couple minutes, Jenny. It could just be a cramp.
Ew! Oh, my God! Jenny Simons crapped her pants!
The doctors say that Jenny Simon barely survived the fall.
All right, cue.
No, not cue!
You said Pete Melman couldn't kill himself. I've made her the number 1 story on Eavesdropper.
Nobody was supposed to kill themselves. Unless you fix this, our deal is off.
Nobody can be made fun of for crapping their pants, and nobody can die.
Yes!
Jesus Christ.
At lunch, you're serving the students pizza, but we're going to put laxatives and Arby's horsey sauce in the pizza so that every kid in the school craps their pants after recess.
That's insane!
Okay, well, if you have a better idea, then why am I here?
How long would it take to organize a Pizza Friday for the students?
What's up?
They've got a video of Pete Melman's mom showing up with fresh underwear.
It's funny that something which should be completely private is put up on a website for everyone to see?
Yeah, dude, that's pretty funny.
Stan Marsh thinks Elise Thompson has a hot butt crack. Stan Marsh wrote, "Dude, you should have been in PE today. Elise Thompson's butt crack was totally showing."
Kenny, what the fuck? How did Eavesdropper get a hold of my email to you?
You like looking at girls' butt cracks, Stan? Do you have any idea how embarrassed I am?
People are gonna forget all about this.
So you didn't email anybody else about Elise Thompson's butt crack, right?
This is an issue of trust and privacy. We have to all work together to put an end to Eavesdropper once and for all. What we have to do is find out who in the school is running Eavesdropper.
Whoever it is just now posted a news story on Eavesdropper. Allison Taft reveals embarrassing secret about Craig Tucker. Hey, wait, that's me.
Where's it coming from?
If it's on the school network, we can track the IP address. In here. It's a rat.
Get it! Don't let him get away!
He's gone!
A stupid rat is in charge of Eavesdropper?
It says here its name is WikiLeaks.
Stop that rat!
I just want you to know that I have a huge crush on you. And
hey! Yep, a few more laxatives on that one. A little more Arby's horsey sauce on there. Mm-hmm.
You sure this will work, Eric?
Enough students will crap their pants to make everyone forget about Pete Melman and Jenny Simons forever. I believe we discussed the little matter of my payment. Give me what I wanted now.
Bring her in, Adler.
Oh my God! Selena Gomez, you actually got her to come!
All right, get her the fuck out of here.
That was amazing.
All right, now get back to class. Adler, get rid of those laxative bottles. There cannot be one piece of evidence of what we did here. Stop that rat! Now, what the hell are we gonna do? The only thing that makes a juicy story go away is a juicier story. Maybe there is a way out of this, but we're gonna have to throw Eric Cartman under the bus.
Yes?
Come on, guys! There he is! Ah! Some kids are stealing my gerbil!
Eric Cartman killed himself. Did you see that? Oh, why would he do it? Oh, wait, here's a suicide note. Mm-hmm. I'm tired of being fat, okay? And I have to end it all, okay?
Please, can this wait? A big story's about to come out on Eavesdropper, and we have the only way to stop it. Stop right there, you
don't
rat!
Let me wait. Stop.
Lemmywinks killed him!
Okay, let's just delete all this tabloid garbage. Okay.
Phew, I'm sure glad that's over with.
Oh, Eric! Eric, I know we kind of threw you under the bus, okay?
It's okay, Mr. Mackey. I'm totally over it.
It was an overly generous move for you to give all the faculty those cupcakes?
Oh, you are most certainly welcome.
Oh! Oh, it's bad! Excuse me, kids, I need to run. Ow! Okay. It's bad!
Those tonsils need to come out. We'll just put you to sleep, Eric, and when you wake up, you'll be tonsil-free.
I'm not going to the hospital, ma'am!
Well, then I guess you don't want all the ice cream you get after the surgery, either.
What do you say, champ? Think you can tough it out?
You did say free ice cream?
Wake up, honey.
It's over?
That's right. You did it, Poopsikins. I'm so proud of you, Eric. Oh, here's the doctor now.
Eric, I'm afraid that we've accidentally infected you with the AIDS virus. During the tonsil surgery, we had to supply you with donor blood. A mistake was made and you were given blood contaminated with HIV. We are very sorry.
You gave me AIDS and you're sorry? Mom, you said nothing would go wrong! Oh. No, this is a joke, right? This is a joke! I can't have AIDS!
I think I owe you some ice cream.
Fuck your ice cream! You all said I'd be fine!
My baby has HIV!
Thank you for coming, everyone. Boys, please take a seat.
What's going on? Are we in trouble?
One of your friends has a serious illness. Eric Cartman has been diagnosed with HIV.
What? Oh, no.
The disease is in very early stages and completely manageable. We need everyone to understand that you can't get the virus from Eric. Don't be afraid of him, just...
Excuse me. Eric Cartman has HIV.
Eric, come on in.
Hey,
hi, Eric.
Hi, Eric.
Hey there.
You know, I think you're a real special little guy.
God damn it, this sucks ass!
Excuse me, I have to step out for a minute.
Is Kyle laughing out there? This isn't a time for funny jokes. People need to understand the seriousness of this illness. Where the hell is everybody?
Excuse me, shouldn't we wait for everyone to arrive before we get started?
I'm afraid AIDS benefits aren't as popular as they used to be. It's all about cancer now.
Of all the times to get AIDS, I get it right when everyone stops giving a crap.
With all of your help, we have raised over $17 for AIDS tonight. I wrote this song for a very brave little boy.
AIDS burger in paradise.
Nobody likes Jimmy Buffett except for frat boys and alcoholic chicks from the South.
Dying of AIDS in the cold dark. How he got AIDS, I haven't a clue.
Fuck you, Jimmy Buffett! Fucking suck! Hey guys, thanks a lot for coming to my AIDS benefit yesterday.
Oh dude, was that yesterday? We forgot.
Seems like all of America's forgot that HIV is a serious disease!
Well, did Elton John sing a song for you?
No, as a matter of fact, Jimmy Buffett came instead. Oh yeah, it's real fucking funny, Kyle!
Cartman, I feel really bad for you.
If you really felt bad, you'd wipe that fucking smirk off your face! Well, any goddamn second, Kyle!
He does feel bad for you, Cartman. He just thinks it's ironic.
Nobody deserves this illness, Stan! And maybe somebody needs to teach Kyle how to have some compassion!
You think HIV is something to be laughed at, Kyle? Let's just see how funny it is now, asshole.
There, there, Bubby, you'll be okay. Oh, doctor, did you find anything?
Mrs. Pavlovsky, has your son ever had a blood transfusion?
No, why?
Have you been having unprotected anal sex?
What? No!
Doctor, what are you saying?
Little Kyle here is infected with HIV.
No, that's impossible!
I'm telling you, you're wrong. There's no way I can have HIV. Unless maybe... That son of a bitch!
Kyle? Kyle!
Pass me the ball, Craig, you stupid asshole.
I'm gonna kill you, Cartman!
Kyle, what?
Why do I have HIV?
Oh, guess it isn't so funny now, is it?
What did you do?
Nothing!
Then why did Butters say he helped you sneak into my room last Friday night? Do you know how serious this is? Thank you!
Break it up, okay? Break it up, okay?
Now, what is this fighting all about?
He purposely infected me with his HIV virus.
Is that true, Eric?
Well, he was being a total dick.
Did you infect Kyle with the HIV virus, yes or no?
Kind of.
Eric, that is not appropriate behavior.
That's right. I think you owe Kyle an apology.
I'm sorry for giving you AIDS, Kyle.
And now, Kyle, maybe you should also admit you were wrong for tattling.
What?
Tattling's bad, okay, because nobody likes a tattletale.
He infected me with AIDS!
Well, Kyle, I guess we're even now. Should we just call it a truce? Should we call it even Stevens now?
I'm going to break everything that you own.
What are you doing? Kyle, stop it! God damn it, don't! No, Kyle, not Clyde Frog. No! Clyde, no, not the Xbox, Kyle. I'm sorry I gave you HIV, all right? Just give me a chance, and I can cure you.
There is no cure, you asshole!
I'm onto something. Magic Johnson, Kyle. He was a basketball player. So he got HIV like 50 years ago, and he's still totally fine. Magic Johnson has some kind of resistance to the virus, Kyle. If we can track him down and isolate his genetic prototype, we have a chance of beating this thing, buddy.
Because if you don't find a cure for HIV, I will break your Xbox.
My God. We need 2 tickets to Los Angeles as soon as possible.
$400 each.
We have to see Magic Johnson right away. We have AIDS.
But I'm sorry, I can't just give away free seats.
We sometimes offer free seats to cancer patients, but AIDS, I...
Forget it, all right? We'll use another airline.
We're so happy to help accommodate you, brave boys. What kind of cancer did you say you have again?
Oh, all over cancer.
These days, I think I'd rather have AIDS than cancer.
Look, shouldn't you be serving people drinks or something? Get out of here!
We're on our way, buddy. Magic Johnson, here we come.
Don't touch me.
Magic, could you come to the front for a minute? 2 brave little buddies who, against all odds, have journeyed across America to find the cure for AIDS.
We were hoping that maybe you have some kind of key that can help us with our disease.
You boys both have the virus? Are you sure?
We're not just sure. We're HIV positive.
Will you stop it with that? What part of this is funny?
funny to you?
I don't think it's funny, Kyle.
Then stop saying you're not just sure you're HIV positive.
Well, excuse me, Kyle, for trying to keep some optimism. You know, sometimes when things seem their darkest, you just need to try and stay HIV positive.
Ah! Ow, fuck, Kyle!
Boys, the truth is, I don't know why my body is so resistant to the virus.
Maybe there's something you've come into contact with that hinders HIV from growing. Can we see where you sleep?
Just a pretty plain old ordinary bedroom. I don't trust banks. I sleep with all my money. Yeah, I like to keep it close for... You don't think that...
It's incredible. Take a look. Now watch what happens when we introduce some cash.
The HIV particles are receding.
If being around lots of cash negatively affects the HIV,
then maybe enough cash shot directly into the bloodstream could kill the virus altogether.
Let's hope to Christ this works.
Cash particles have completely replaced all the HIV in Kyle's blood. You just found the cure for AIDS. Hey, they just found the cure for AIDS. You just have to inject yourself with all your cash. I am pleased to announce that there is no trace of the HIV virus in either Kyle Broflosky or Eric Cartman. These two brave friends.
Oh, stop. We're not friends. He's the one who infected me with AIDS.
These two brave lovers found the cure and helped the world. Here is Jimmy Buffett.
What? Oh, no.
Cure burger in paradise.
Oh, God damn it. I'm never getting my tonsils out again. I'm still breaking your Xbox. Kyle, no!
Well, believe it, friends. The impossible has happened. Kenny has a girlfriend.
This is serious. They've been going out for almost 2 weeks now.
She's the only girl in school whose family is actually poorer than Kenny's.
You guys, I think we have a big problem. Well, I just talked to Brad Dixon. Tammy Warner is bad news. All the fifth graders call her a slut on account of she gave this kid Dave Darsky a BJ in the parking lot of TGI Fridays. Ask anybody in fifth grade. Tammy Warner is a total slut.
That bitch! Kenny gave his heart to her, and she's just gonna throw it in his face! All right, come on, guys. Kenny, hey, Kenny!
Kenny, we know you really like this girl, but...
Your girlfriend's a slut, dude. She even gave a kid named Dave Darsky a BJ.
Woohoo! Woohoo! Woohoo!
He took it pretty well.
Woohoo!
There's a lot of rumors going around about me that I agreed to give a boy a BJ. It's true. And it wasn't my fault! See, I was watching the Disney Channel, and that show came on with the Jonas Brothers. Every time I see them, I get so tingly, and it just happened. Can you forgive me, Ken?
2 tickets to the Jonas Brothers concert.
Boom.
Kenny, you're the best for bringing me here. Isn't this awesome?
Slow down, so I'm ready.
My giant tickles!
I need your love, cause my mom doesn't like it. You would take your love and go. We're married to pull down you. See, I can't wait till you are mine, but it must be.
Good night, Denver. We love you all.
Oh my God! I just want to attack you, Kenny.
Oh, no.
Little girl in the red. Band would like you to come backstage.
Oh my God! It's a dream come true.
Who?
All right, right this way, girls.
Not you.
Oh! What the?
Why do you think they called us back here?
So we can give them blowjobs.
Well, I'm not doing it.
Here, girls. Let's just get to the blowjobs.
Look, we called you back here because we want to share our love of Christ with you. And see if you'll wear purity rings from now on.
We all wear purity rings. It means we are going to be pure and not have sex until we're married.
Okay.
So how'd it go last night? Purity ring?
Hey, calm down. You're too young to be getting BJs anyway.
I've got a ring on my finger to remind me what I cannot do. I can't hang out with my buddies and get into trouble. But who needs sex and drugs and partying when we can cook a meal then sit around and watch Netflix? And if we get bored, it won't be a problem, cause we can just hang out with other couples who wear these rings.
Yeah, we found out that once you wear purity rings, it's best to hang out with other couples that do. Got more in common, isn't that right, Sarah?
We adore Grey's Anatomy, don't we, Nancy?
We look forward to it all week long.
Good to remind me what I cannot do.
And cut.
This is bullpucky.
Uh-oh, looks like we've got a problem.
We have decided, as a band, not to wear purity rings anymore.
We'll just leave you alone.
So, I guess we have some issues, huh?
Look, we just want our concerts to be about our music, and not about purity rings.
Oh, gosh, fellas, let me explain this to you one more time. You have to wear the purity rings, because that's how we can sell sex to little girls, huh? See, if we make the posters with little girls reaching for your junk, then you have to wear purity rings, or else Disney Company looks bad.
Well, maybe we'll just refuse to go on stage. Woof!
You don't fucking touch me like that, you little piece of shit! Now, do we have a problem?
No, Mr. Mouse. No, Mr. Mouse.
All right, now, get out there and make me some goddamn money!
We've had just about enough, dude. You've been blowing us off for 2 weeks now. What's up?
Grey's Anatomy? Kenny! What kind of douchebag garbage are you watching?
You guys, I think this is serious. There's something really wrong with him.
These Disney douchebags are the ones causing all this!
Now, guys, a lot has been made about your purity rings. Can you tell us about those?
Well, we wear these to symbolize how pure we are and how we don't approve of things that are naughty or filthy. Hey, those Jonas Brothers are assholes! Yeah, their purity rings turned our friend into a douche!
Who the hell are these guys?
Cartman?
Who do you work for, DreamWorks?
We don't work for anybody.
Oh boy, I sure believe that!
What the hell did you do to us?
Shut up! You better start talking right now!
We came on our own because our friend's purity ring is killing him!
You're lying! I'll cut you up!
You see? We were right about the purity rings!
We've all angered God!
You think God is in control here? I am in control! I've been in control since the 50s, in case you haven't noticed! I have worked too long and too hard to have anybody fuck this up! Where would you be without me, Jonas Brothers? Your music sucks and you know it! And that's because little girls are fucking stupid! And the purity rings make it okay to do whatever I want! Oh! Hello, folks! Now, take it easy! No! No, goddammit, no! Shut up! Shut up! Vengeance is mine! You're all ants and I'm your destroyer!
Aw, Ken. Look what we've become. Let's take them off and just be kids again. Oh, I feel better already. What say you and me? Go to TGI Fridays.
Woohoo!
Let us all be reminded that syphilis is still a deadly disease. This young boy learned the hard way.
I told him. Woman's mouth is the most germ-ridden place on earth, I said. Statistically, the most unsafe place for a man to put his penis, I said. Yeah. Big Wayne Slammer. That's pretty cool. Let's see. Black Jackal, bendable neck. Asshole! Cock!
Ma'am, is that your son over there?
My son has Tourette syndrome. He can't control what he says. All right, Thomas, maybe we should go? Here, let's buy you a nice toy to take home.
Dude, that mom is cool. Cock nut! What's your problem, kid?
My son Thomas has Tourette syndrome.
Mom, can we just go home?
It's okay, Thomas, they understand.
I want to go! Are you telling me that if you have this Tourette syndrome, you can say whatever you want all the time and never get in trouble?
It's a neurological disorder. He can't help it.
I've got a golden ticket.
It started about 4 days ago, Doctor.
Pussy!
Oh!
Pussy!
It almost seems like his symptoms are like those in something called Tourette syndrome.
What is that, Mommy?
Tourette's is a hereditary disease. It doesn't just suddenly start. On the other hand, Tourette's does often develop later in a child's life, getting progressively worse. We don't know very much about Tourette's, I'm afraid, but we will get your son all the help we can.
But what about school, Doctor? They won't understand that I can't control what I say.
We'll make sure everyone understands your disease and gives you the compassion you deserve.
Thank you, faggot! Hey, Wendy. Dumb bitch! Oh, sorry. Ginger retard!
Dude, you better watch it. The principal's right over there.
Good morning, Principal Victoria. Shitballs!
Good morning, Eric.
Well, Carmen has some mental disease called Tourette syndrome or something.
If I could say shitballs to the principal, I'd be so happy. I guess you might have noticed my awkward tics. I just want you to know that I can't control it.
It's okay, Eric. We all understand and we think you're very brave.
He's faking.
Hey, excuse me, everyone. I need to have a moment alone with my good friend Kyle. Kyle, apparently you missed the school assembly yesterday, but I've been diagnosed with a very serious mental condition.
You do not have Tourette syndrome, fat ass.
Oh, okay, you figured me out. It's like a magic cloak that makes me impervious to getting in trouble.
Whatever.
Good morning, Mr. Mackey. Ass pussy!
Okay, so what do we get when we multiply a negative number?
Dick tits!
If we apply what we've just learned, we see that all negatives can...
Spooge, balls, bloody vaginal belch.
You guys, don't laugh.
All right, kids, let's just try to focus on learning, okay?
Tampon dick shit!
Will you knock it off already?
I'd give anything to be normal like you.
Don't push me, asshole!
Kyle, watch your language!
If I could yell tampon dick shit in the classroom, I'd be so happy.
I don't think I can teach my class anymore.
Mr. Donaldson has come from the Tourette's Tolerance and Understanding Foundation.
Hello, Mrs. Garrison.
Ass!
I want to help your class better understand this illness. Piss!
Carmen's Tourette's isn't real. He's faking.
You think people with Tourette's are faking? We aren't faking, young man. Trust me. Nobody wants this illness. Ass piss! Then if you wouldn't mind, I'd like to take this bully to see that Tourette's is very real.
I wanted him to meet all of you so he could try to understand Tourette's.
Tourette's is like a cough or a sneeze.
A lot of people with Tourette's have different tics. My tic is that I have to bend my neck and snap my fingers. Sometimes it can be embarrassing to have Tourette's, but I've learned I shouldn't be mad at myself.
These kids can't control their actions. Ass!
Look, I was just suggesting that maybe this one person could control what he said, but just didn't. For fun. You want to know about fun? Going to public places knowing you're going to make a fool of yourself. My dad, he divorced my mom, said he'd still be around, but I only see him at Christmas time now. The worst part is I know how lonely my mom is. A lot of times I know she'd be better off if I was dead.
So then you apologize for what you said before?
No. No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Well, Mr. and Miss Pravlosky, I think your son has learned a lot and he appears to be honestly remorseful. I think the only thing left now is for your son to apologize to his little classmate.
I'm sorry.
I've learned to deal with intolerance. And it means a lot that you're standing here apologizing with your dad and lovely mother.
Well, I think we can all put this behind us now. Piss out my ass!
Piss out your ass right onto Kyle's mom's fat fucking Jew face! Jeez, that was a bad one. Isn't having Tourette's awesome?
You probably know me from To Catch a Predator, where we bust men looking for sex with children.
Oh, God! Oh, no!
What are you doing here?
I'm just being stupid, I guess.
Won't you do a special report on me, so that the world can learn to accept us instead of just laugh? Donkey Boner!
This Saturday on Dateline, I will be bringing you Eric's story, live and uncensored.
This Saturday, I will go on national television, live. I will say horrible things on the air, and people will call me brave. I have free reign to say anything I want, and you get into trouble if you try and stop me. I've managed not only to get away with saying whatever I want at school, on the bus, at the dinner table, but this Saturday I will actually say anything I want on national television.
You are not going to go on national television and spew a bunch of hate speech about Jewish people.
Do you have any idea how liberating it is to say whatever comes to mind? Whatever enters my brain, I can just say without thinking about it. Big titties, butt munch. I wet my bed last night.
You aren't gonna get away with this, you stupid asshole!
That was weird.
Tonight, Eric Cartman will go on television and become the spokesman for Tourette's syndrome.
Oh, no.
Thanks, everybody. You've all been so understanding and supportive of my illness. And I also just want to say that I'm making this all up! I'm making this all up to you for putting up with my mental disorder. I cry at night because I don't have a dad. What the hell is going on? What I meant to say was ass liquor cum balls. And I'm secretly in love with Patty Nelson. Excuse me, I need a toilet. Bathroom! Bathroom! Butters, do you think it's possible that you can lose your ability to filter what you say? If somebody got used to saying whatever came to their mind, could they start saying things that they would normally never say?
Who are you talking about?
My cousin. One time, my cousin and I touched wieners. Ah!
You and your cousin touched wieners?
I didn't say that. Yes, I did, but why? Ah!
Is there a problem, sweetie?
I just need to... My cousin and I touched each other's...
I just want to thank everyone for coming. My cousin and I touched wiener. Winter is a cold time of year.
Good luck on Dateline tonight.
Dateline. Right. I touched my cousin's wiener.
Tonight, an inside look at Tourette's syndrome.
I'm afraid I can't do the show. My grandma just died. That's not true. My grandma's fine.
Why don't you have a seat? Go ahead and take a seat.
But I'm not going to do this.
Take a seat right over there. What are you doing here?
You don't understand. All of a sudden, I can't control what I say. My Tourette's has gotten worse. Before, I just blurted out cool stuff about Jews being lame and stuff. But now it's gotten really bad.
You know, one time, I was doing a show called To Catch a Predator. We almost caught this pedophile, but then he ran from us because he didn't want to be on Dateline. So we tracked him down to his house. He shot himself. Be a shame if we had to track you down and you shot yourself.
Tonight, an inside look at Tourette syndrome. In a few minutes, you will meet little Eric Cartman.
How did I get myself into this?
God, please, I know I screwed up. But see, I get it now. You gave us a filter because people don't want to hear things like, I touched penises with my cousin! Please, God, don't make me embarrass myself on national television.
Tango, this is Foxtrot. Are you in position? Copy, Foxtrot. Tango in position. No, you were right. That fat kid is faking it. If he goes on TV, more people will think that having Tourette's is fun. All right, then we go with the plan. Just like To Catch a Predator. The first guy's here.
Are you cute, Billy 182?
Yeah, I was chatting with you online.
This is your house? Your parents aren't home, are they?
Go on inside. I made brownies. I'm just gonna slip into something more comfortable. Cock!
Okay. Oh, this ain't no house. Chris Hansen! Oh no, it's a setup, I knew it!
Sir, why don't you take a seat right over there?
Oh!
Not again.
Surprise, fat ass! I went online posing as a boy who would have sex with older men and told them to meet me here. Yeah, go on in. There's a hot tub inside.
Oh no, it's Chris Hansen! What the hell is going on?
Oh God, it's Chris Hansen! I knew it!
Hey, you have something to do with this? Answer me! Why don't you take a seat?
Suck it! Asshole liquor dick fart!
Why, I'll tell on you!
Wow, you're the coolest kid in the world. If I could call Chris Hansen an asshole licking dick fart to his face, I would be so happy. Could I just, like, hang out with you sometime?
You aren't going on Dateline. What do you have to say now?
Thank you, Cal. I asked God to send someone to help me, and you came, Cal.
No, I beat you.
See ya, Cal? I gotta get to a psychiatrist and learn to control what I say.
Oh, shit!
I don't get it, Kenny. Why did you buy razors and shaving cream?
Why would you shave your balls?
Girls like shaved balls?
What girl is gonna see your bows?
Oh, Jesus, there's another one! Another pan flute band. There's bands like this everywhere you go lately?
Yeah, I saw like three of those bands down in Denver yesterday.
I think Kenny likes it.
God!
I'm out of here. See you guys.
Tonight, the Travel Channel takes you to London.
They're in London too?
Time for dinner, guys!
Where's Dad?
Ever since your father got that stupid video camera, he thinks he has to film everything the family does.
Marsh family gathered for another dinner. There's Shelly. Excited about dinner, Shelly?
Turn it off, Dad!
Wave to the camera stand. Oh, neato! It's one of those Peruvian pan flute bands!
You guys, check this out. I saw another Peruvian flute band outside my house last night. Guess how much money they made selling their crappy CDs?
Over $200.
I'm starting to realize it's like the easiest job in the world. We could do that. We get some instruments and some costumes and then make some crappy pan flute music CDs on my computer.
We are gonna make so much fucking money, you guys.
Yeah!
Woohoo!
Craig, dude, how you doing, bro? Remember you were telling us how your grandma gave you $100 for your birthday?
How would you like to turn that $100 into $1,000?
We have chosen you to join our Peruvian flute band.
We just need your money to buy some instruments and make some CDs.
And we'll double your money in one afternoon.
You guys never hang out with me, but now you want me to be in a band with you because my grandma gave me $100.
Craig, don't be an asshole.
I'll go get the money.
All right, guys, just like we rehearsed it. And a one, and a two, and a...
Wow, that's such cultural music.
Por favor, buy our CDs de musica.
How cultural.
This is awesome.
Hey. No trabajar aquí. Vaya. No playa la música en la promenade. No es bueno. No es bueno. on, guys. No, no es bueno! No trabajar aquí! Ha! Serves you right, assholes!
One more over here! Let's go, get him out!
Hey, back off!
Make sure all pan flute music CDs are contained!
Excuse us, hello? Excuse me, sir! There's been a misunderstanding. Could I talk to you for a minute?
Get back! I'm not buying any of your damn CDs!
Señor, comprar CD la música?
Hey, Craig, how would you like to invest in a Peruvian flute band? You can double your money in one afternoon. Come on, Craig.
Attention, Peruvian flute bands! Tomorrow you will be boarding ships, which will take you to Guantanamo Bay, where you will spend the rest of your lives.
We can't go to Guantanamo Bay!
I'm sure our parents are freaking out right now trying to find us.
Please, Mr. and Mrs. Tucker, do you have any idea where they could have gone?
No, I'm telling you, this isn't like Craig at all.
It's like the boys just vanished.
Randy, will you put that thing down?
Hey, I'm worried about him too, Sharon.
Well then, stop being an idiot and help!
All we know is they were seen hanging out with Craig and now they're gone.
This is exactly why I told Kyle not to hang around there, boy.
No, wait just a minute.
I'm just saying that your son has some problems.
Like every kid doesn't have some problems.
Obviously, Craig has gotten him into some kind of trouble.
Oh, my God.
Oh, this is good.
Every major city is reporting zero Peruvian flute bands. We got them all. We have to take out the place these flute bands came from so they never come again.
We don't know where they came from, sir.
Well, think about it, idiot. The country is in the name!
We checked the entire map. There isn't a country called Peruvian anywhere.
Not Peruvian, retards, Peru! Now I want a plan in place to take out Peru once and for all.
It seems a little extreme.
Peruvian flute bands will never stop annoying us unless they are stopped at the source.
One of the pan flute bands was caught trying to escape.
This is a mistake, sir. We aren't really a Peruvian flute band. We're just kids, you know? We're just trying to make some money.
Look, we're from Colorado. We grew up in the United States.
We speak English. And we're white.
Well, what do you think?
I don't know what to make of it, sir. Clearly they are a Peruvian flute band, and yet they aren't.
They're obviously some kind of hybrid.
Perhaps a Peruvian flute band mated with one of our females.
If they are the hybrid we're talking about, then they could be our way of taking out Peru once and for all.
Do you guys know why nobody else at school likes hanging out with you? Because you're always doing stuff like this. And then it backfires, and then you end up in some foreign country or in outer space or something.
You're being extremely negative, Craig.
Maybe you are on our side and maybe you aren't, but if you help us, we'll get you home. We are going to send you to their capital. Either you go to Peru or you get locked up forever with the other flute bands.
The last of the Peruvian flute bands have successfully been eradicated from every part of the world. Pretty nice not having any Peruvian flute music there, I suspect. Really welcome silence, Tom. Everyone is really enjoying the peace. What the? Jesus Christ! There's something else here! Oh my God, what is that thing? It's Barry! Barry! Okay, obviously something different has shown up.
Was there ever a moment when you guys first came up with the genius plan to become a Peruvian flute band that any of you said, hey, you know, this plan might backfire? No, that never occurs to you. Because you guys are jerks.
Craig's just being a dick because we're having a tough time right now.
I'm being a dick. You guys took my birthday buddy, got me arrested, and sent to Miami with no way home except to take down the country of Peru, and I'm being a dick.
All right, fine, Craig. When we get back home, we'll get you your money back, and we'll never talk to you again. How's that?
That would be great. Thank you.
Please, I don't know where else to turn. The police haven't been any help. I think our boys might really be in trouble this time. Thank you. Randy, I swear to God if you don't put that thing away! I mean it, Randy, that's enough! You don't have to videotape every single...
The hell was that?
Oh my God!
Ah! What did that? What is that thing? Ah! Oh my God!
Go back the other way!
Oh God.
If I die, let it be known that it is because four guys I don't even like from school lied to me and took my birthday buddy.
How are we supposed to know that pan flute bands would be outlawed?
I don't get it. They said the military would meet us here.
This is Connor in Washington.
There's nobody here to meet us. It's like they sent us to no man's land.
They're attacking people, dying, guinea pigs,
all over!
Michaels, Harrison, anybody! Whatever's going on out there is huge.
The head of Homeland Security ordered you to fly us to Peru, but had you land way up in the Andes Mountains of Peru so that other government people could meet us and then tell us how to go to the capital of Peru and take down their government.
Yes, that was the order.
And that makes sense to you?
Actually, the whole rounding up of the Panflu bands didn't make sense to any of us either.
So could you just fly us home, please?
The plan was to have a refueling truck meet us here. We don't have enough gas to fly anyplace.
So we've got to find another way out of here.
It's starting to look that way.
Oh, that's awesome. This is fun. Let's walk for miles through a spooky jungle.
Look at that. No lights on, nothing. It's like humans have never been to this part of Peru.
This entire area of Peru isn't even charted on the maps.
This whole valley is strange. Just look at the size of that fruit. Ain't that a peach? How do you like them apples?
Take a look at this. They look like beehive combs.
Dude, what is this place?
It's like an unknown valley that time forgot, where everything grows huge.
I decided to follow you guys, and now I'm in Land of the Giants Lost World.
You make it sound like we always want to be in situations like this, but we don't have any choice.
Stuff just happens.
Stuff just happens. You just wind up being sent by the government to take down the city of Lima, only to wind up in Land of the Giants Lost World. You know what stuff happens to most kids? They fall off their bikes. They get swindled out of their birthday money.
Look, wherever we are, I think we better keep moving.
I've got the video camera. This is Randy Marsh. 20 minutes ago, some huge creatures attacked our town. I barely made it back to the house. And there's Shelly. Wave to the camera, Shelly.
Randy, will you put down that camera? We need to figure out what to do. We have to see what the news is saying.
This is a shot of New York City where the giant guinea pigs have also attacked.
Jesus, this thing is worldwide?
Look at that thing! Randy, what are we gonna do?
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!
Go, Randy, run!
Okay, we're down. Oh, look at that! Oh! Go through that way.
Ah, my arm! My arm!
There's Sharon and Shelly running. Wave to the camera, Shelly! Ah! In there, in there! Oh god. Oh god, I'm so startled.
Randy, put down that...
Ah! It's gonna kill us!
Hold on, I need to get a shot of it from outside. Here we see a view from outside the bus.
What the hell are you doing?
Here's Sharon and Shelly on the roof of Best Buy. We ran up here to get off the streets. There's Chris and Linda, and their son Butters.
Hello.
Chris, what is that?
That's a new sound.
Those aren't guinea pigs!
Go! Go down the stairs now!
And we are now in front of giant bees. The giant bees have been seen in the U.S. and Europe.
There's another one right there!
Oh my god!
It stung me! It stung me!
We're in the grocery store now. Some other survivors here. The highway's unreachable. There's guinea rats all over it.
Oh, I've even seen some guinea spiders out there.
Look, I think we need to find a way out under the city. In the sewers? Can't be safe down there.
What are we gonna do?
Something's inside the store.
Help!
Travis, no!
It's a guinea bear!
No, it's a guinea mouse, stupid!
Mom, I can't see.
There. Okay. It's been 3 days now since the guinea pigs and the guinea bees attacked. We've taken shelter at the Outback Steakhouse. Say hey, guys.
What is that? What is that?
It's a Guineasaurus Rex!
What do you think about the Guineasaurus Rex, Shelly? Oh, that's good. There's Shelly with the Guineasaurus Rex in the background. Oh, I know. Hold out your palm so it looks like you're holding the Guineasaurus Rex.
Randy! You are putting down that goddamn camera!
I think we're just heading deeper into the mountains. Hey, look at this.
Let's see what's in there.
That's why you guys get into these situations. Because when you come across a spooky ancient ruin, you say, let's see what's in there.
I don't think anybody's been in here for centuries.
You guys, look at this. It's a wall of ancient drawings.
It's a Peruvian flute band.
Dude,
Dude, it's Craig!
What?
Dude, Craig, what's going on?
I have no idea.
Well, do you mind telling us what you're doing on an ancient Incan wall, Craig?
I don't know.
You hear that? It sounds like water.
Yeah, it's coming from up there.
Wow.
All right, let's go.
I'm not following you guys anymore. Every time bad things happen, you guys end up putting yourselves deeper into the middle of it.
Hey, we aren't the ones on an ancient temple prophecy wall, butt wipe!
I don't care. I am choosing not to be a part of this anymore.
Craig, dude, wait up! Dude, Craig, we should go back now. Hey, look, there's something here!
Nope.
Dude, this is boring. This is just a bunch of walking around.
Yep, nice and boring.
Craig! No, how did you get here?
Sir, is everything all right?
Shoot them! They're a Peruvian band that escaped. We must keep them contained.
The Peruvian flute bands were keeping the guinea creatures away. Whatever's happening to the world is happening because you guys got rid of all the flute bands.
Go look! It's all an ancient Incan prophecy.
Am you Craig?
I didn't say anything.
You see, for thousands of years, horrid creatures have lived in the Guinea Valley of Peru. But the prophecy foretold that one day the creatures would be unleashed, and I have made that happen. You will all die on this mountain. You're some kind of monster. Arrgh!
Jesus Christ!
I'm not going to ruin your plans. I'll just walk away.
No! Ah, curse you, Craig!
My name is Craig Tucker. I stopped the Guinea Pirates from taking over the Earth. All the Peruvian flute bands were released and drove the Guinea creatures back to the Andes Mountains. All over the world, survivors were found.
Here, look, look! Oh, I didn't have a tape in it.
The Guinea Pirate lived, but was taken to prison to live out the rest of his days. And people all over the world learned to support their local Peruvian flute bands and buy their CDs. As for me, I was returned home by Homeland Security. My parents were so happy. We are but players on the stage of life. And I also learned to never listen when people come asking you for money.
Sir, we have a problem. It attacked the guards, got out of its holding cell.
My God, are you telling me?
It broke out of prison.
What the hell's going on?
Sweetie, your friends and I have all chipped in, and we're going to send you up to a weight management retreat.
Fat camp?
Yes, fat camp.
Mom, tell them! Tell them I'm not fat, I'm just big boned!
Oh, sweetie, those were all lies. You're just fat.
Have you got any candy?
No. My mom says I ain't to eat no candy here. I'm supposed to lose weight.
Losing weight is fun, right, gang?
Right.
Oh, no, kids! It's glutinous fat! I can knock it out with exercise and proper diet. I guess we took care of that bad old fat, didn't we, kids?
Yeah.
Will somebody put this retard out of his misery? I'm starving. This is it. I'm going to die here.
I've got some fudge hidden up my ass. You want some?
Yeah, I'm not falling for that one again. Now the only question is, do we go home to our traitor mom and friends, or do we start a new life on the run? An ice cream truck! Hey, wait! Boy, am I glad to see you!
Alrighty, do you want this kind or this kind?
Huh? They tricked us again, huh?
Hey, kids!
Looks like we had some attempted escapees again tonight.
You can't leave!
There is no escape!
Ah, damn it!
Thanks for coming, everybody. I would like to present to you the new Eric Cartman.
Hey, dude!
He lost 40 pounds at his fat camp.
What the hell did they do with all the fat? There must have been enough to last an Eskimo family months.
You know, Cap, there was a time when your fat jokes would have gotten to me. In fact, I'd say I'm a little bit trimmer than you, fat boy. Just kidding, Cap.
Dude, I don't know if I'm gonna like the new Eric Cartman.
Did you like the old one?
Good point.
All right, I got the goods. Some candy bars, a few donuts, and some beef gravy.
All right, throw it over.
One thing. I want a bigger cut.
I'll bump you up to 10%.
20.
I suck my best!
Fine, then I shall bid you good day.
Wait. Fine, 20. But just remember that your parents think you're at the drug rehab center next door.
I don't know what we're doing wrong, Susan. These kids aren't losing the weight.
We'll just have to give them more time. They'll do it.
The Cartman store is open!
2 donuts and a pack of licorice, please.
2 donuts and a pack of licorice.
Because I'm always going to be fat. And I swore to my mama that I'd lose the weight.
Chad, you know what you need? You need a friend. A chocolate friend. That'll just be $4. There you go.
Please, Mr. Sanders.
No, I have had it.
What's happening?
Horace's parents want to take him home.
Look at these kids. They're not getting any thinner. Your time is up.
Yeah, your time is up.
Dad, I...
What?
Nothing.
Goodbye, Chad.
Wait a second. This isn't right. Mom, Dad, we've been eating candy this whole time.
Eric Cartman's been sneaking in junk food.
Shut up, you half-Chad.
If you take us back, we promise we won't cheat.
Well, what the heck? Maybe when you're all done, you could teach me a thing or two, huh, son?
But I know deep down that if I took responsibility and really tried hard...
Oh, no, not you. You're not welcome here anymore.
Yeah!
But screw you, fat asses!
Hey, save me! Who will save me?
James West, cowboy and repster.
If we save her, I'm going to take off her pants and play slip and slide.
Look out, Artemis Cloud Frog! It's a giant metal spider! Bang! Bang, bang!
The babysitter's here. Come on downstairs.
But me and Artemis Cloud Frog still have to do our love scene with Selma Hayek.
Come down as soon as you're done.
Well, I'm a badass cowboy living in the cowboy day.
Thank you so much for babysitting little Eric, Shelley. Eric's snooky time is 9 o'clock sharp. And if he gets cranky, just play tummy rub-rubs with him. Oh, and don't mind the cat. She's just being loud because she's in heat.
Kelly, that's a bad goddamn Kelly!
You do what the babysitter tells you, okay?
Uh-huh.
Bye, kids!
Well, go put that pizza in the oven, bitch. I'm hungry.
I don't know how you treat your other babysitters, but when I'm babysitting, you're nothing but a little turd.
Got it? You can't hit me. Didn't you see those nanny videos on TV?
So you go to the kitchen and you make us that pizza before I snap you in half like the little turd stick you are.
God damn it. Any problems, contact Eric's mommy at 303. I'm gonna call mom and tell her that the babysitter's having a boyfriend come over.
And so I said, you're a little turd, and he will...
Damn it!
But one...
Hey, I need to use the phone!
Oh, hold on a second, Carrie.
I'm gonna get her, kitty. Mark my words. Shut the hell up, Kelly!
They mostly come at night.
They mostly come at night. Hey, I was watching Aliens on TV.
Well, I'm watching Friends, turd.
Hey, is Shelly around?
Hey, Skyler. He's my boyfriend.
What? He's like 50 years old.
He's 22.
Dude, that's not cool.
And now back to Wild Animal World.
The male lion positions himself behind the female, notices his large swollen balls. The female lion says hello to Mr. Winky. The male lion is enticed by the female's supple breasts and... Quickly and suddenly, the male is finished. He promises he'll call her tomorrow. She's moving right in. Looks like the male lion is screwed.
Come on, babe. How long have we known each other?
8 days tomorrow.
And I still don't get any action.
Maybe just one kiss.
Mm. Hey, what are you doing? I'm gonna tell my mom on you. You ate all the pizza. I'm calling my mom right now.
Yes, again.
Give me that phone number. I am not gonna be bossed around by a chick. God damn it, Teddy. You have to calm down. Here, I'll get you some catnip.
Black darkness fills my icy cell!
You're such an amazing poet, Skylar!
Isn't? I see your pretty lips and I want to kiss them.
Wow. Oh, Skylar, I love you.
Mmm.
Ha ha, Sherrod, you are!
Give me that picture! Open this door!
I'm gonna show this picture to my mom when she gets home.
Your mom doesn't get home for 3 more hours.
You're never gonna get this picture.
I'm gonna bust this door down.
I'm putting this picture of the babysitter and her boyfriend on your collar. You have to take this picture to mommy, kitty. Take the picture to mommy. Hurry, kitty. You're my only hope. That's it, Mr. Kitty.
I invited the guys in the band over so that we can practice.
Your band can't practice here.
Don't stand between me and my dreams, babe.
Just keep the volume down. Eric, your mom's been in an accident.
Is she okay?
She's dead.
Ha ha!
I knew it was a turd trick, and I opened the door because Mitchell Kitty is on his way right now to my mom's party with the picture.
And that's why I went outside and got him.
Okay. Ah, damn it! Ah!
Check. Okay, ready? This is a song I wrote for you, Shelly. When I saw her walking down the street, I thought she was Shelly.
You're the crappiest band I've ever heard. Oh my God, somebody shoot me in the head. You get out now and respect my authority. Ow!
What do you think, Shelly?
I think you guys need some work.
Well, I'd like to see you do any better, bitch.
Hey, man, don't be shy.
I'll try. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Too many turds are heading my way. Passing by turds whenever. Feel free to mark my words. I'm a dozen sphincter loving turds. Turds!
Ma'am, the babysitter has her boyfriend over.
That's impossible, hon. I told her no visitors.
Her boyfriend is here. Don't you believe me?
Not really, hon.
I'll never be able to prove that son of a bitch was here.
May I speak in record, Bear? Of course.
We're gonna go outside to watch the meteor shower. I'm locking you in your room till we get back in, turd.
Will you tell me what it looked like, the meteor shower? They mostly only come every few years.
All right, get your turd coat. You can come see the meteor shower with us.
You mean it?
But don't bug me and Skylar. Come on.
Yes, yes. What a beautiful night. It is Saturday, the 12th at 10:45. That, of course, is the voice of my babysitter, Shelly Marsh, age 12. Do you have anything to say, Skylar? Shelly's boyfriend, who is sitting right now? Ah!
No!
Give it up, babe.
No!
Why the hell not?
Because I'm 12.
You're not putting out, then I'm moving on. Screw you, prude bitch. Me and my badass guitar are going home. Hasta.
Gotcha. Shelly, guess who's busted?
I don't care. I can't believe I trusted him. I'm so stupid.
What kind of scumbag asshole dates 12-year-old girls?
You're right. He is a scumbag. I wish I could get him back.
I could help you.
Really? You would do that?
Just let me get my cowboy hat.
Selma Hayek? Whoa, she's hot.
We don't have much time.
This won't take me long.
Hurry up in there.
I'm almost done.
Over here, please help me. I am lost and I have no clothes.
No clothes, right.
I'm right here, Miss Hayek.
Please help me. I will give you tacos.
Dude, somebody tricked me. My guitar! No!
Thanks for all your help, Eric. You're okay.
Oh, my God!
They're having a cat orgy. Your mom's gonna be home soon. We're gonna get busted.
Come on, kitties. Outside. Come on, come on.
I'm gonna get you. Oh, my God!
Hi, kids. I'm home.
Well, let's clean up the house. Looks like everything turned out okay.
That's how it goes in the Wild Wild West. Got yo yo bang bang!
Dude, you're not gonna believe what Cartman has! 4 tickets for the Raging Pussies. We're going tomorrow night. Cartman's got the bus schedule all figured out.
Hold on, I'll be right back. My parents said I can't go.
Well, of course your parents said you can't go.
Demi, you don't ask if you can go. I'm telling my parents I'm staying at Stan's house.
Oh.
Well, no, I already told them.
Well, I guess you're screwed then.
Just give me some time to work on them. But what if I do a bunch of chores around the house? Come on, you're being unfair.
All right, fine, Kyle. You can go to the Raging Pussies concert if you can bring democracy to Cuba.
Oh, jeez. Dear Mr. Castro, my name is Kyle. And if I had just one wish in the whole world, if I had one wish, it'd be for Cuba to change. Because I think that all the Cubans are in pain.
Llamar a todos juntos!
Once again, this does mark the end of communism in Cuba.
I did it! Now I can go to the Raging Pussies!
No, you can't.
Well, I wish I didn't have any parents!
Kyle!
Parents can be pretty cruel sometimes, dude.
Well, you could make them go away for a while.
All you gotta do is call the police and say that your parents both molested you. When I wanted to get rid of my mom's last boyfriend, I just called the police and said he was molesting me, and I haven't seen him for 3 months.
Wow! 3 months without parents! Okay, molested, bad touch.
Yeah, and cry. Oh, he's ready.
Oh my God, this isn't happening! I would never touch my children like that!
They'll never be able to hurt you again.
All right!
Just take those old records off the shelf. Same
parents molested me too.
I like that old time rock and roll.
Notice anything? There's not an adult left in town. Then it's ours.
Can I help you folks?
Yes, we need a mechanic to look at our car.
Look, we're in a bit of a spot here. I've got a very important job interview tomorrow morning in Breckenridge, so I have to get my car fixed fast. Is there another garage in town?
No.
How about a phone? Can we just use the phone?
Phone here doesn't work. I'm afraid the only phone that does work is over in Treasure Cove. Show them where it is.
This is the end of Smiley Town.
Well, can you help us find the phone, please?
Hell no. I'm not crossing the white line.
Well, hello. What's your name?
We want to play.
Mark, I'm scared.
We want to play with you.
Get off me!
Oh, God, Mark, help!
Crossing the white line!
We demand to see an adult this instant.
I got new orders. I'm supposed to take you to see the mayor.
The mayor. Good. Finally.
Mr. and Mrs. Cartner, as the mayor of Smiley Town, I would like to ask you a few questions.
What the hell is going on here? Where are all your parents?
You mean the birth givers. They're not around. I'm afraid you'll find all the phones quite out of service.
No phones either? How do you communicate?
Butters, I need an ETA on the car, stat.
It's going to be about 3 days.
Just tell me how to get to a phone or a car.
Spitball! Ah! You see what we're dealing with here, and they will try to kill one of us. If you help us, we'll get you what you need.
Look, if getting the stupid book will get me a cell phone, I don't care.
Look, here's the book they've been talking about that makes no sense.
My God, Mark! Oh, Mark, let's get out of here. Oh, Mark!
The fat kid told us to take it.
Sorry about them. Kindergartners are kind of spazzes. How come you want to help the fat ass? You got foolied, Outlander. We're the only ones with a working phone. And if you had taken our book, then it's one of us who dies tonight at Carousel.
I'll do anything to get to a phone.
All right. Everybody gather around. We're going to tell the story of the before time again. The fat ass came up with a way to have all the birth givers disappear by using the magic M word. Soon we were without power, water, fresh food, but we tried to survive under the guidance of the provider. The town split sides, and that's when the provider got angry. So now every night the provider must be appeased at Carousel. We need their book so one of ours doesn't die.
Let me get this straight. If I go get the fat kid's book on the other side of the white line, you'll show me where a cell phone is?
Yes, no foolies.
Linda, I want you to just go back to the car and wait for me, all right?
Mark, I'm scared.
I know, but this will all be over soon.
Oh, God.
I think I found the problem, ma'am. The broken window roller upper.
Oh, no.
Where is your husband?
Seize her!
All right, I got the book for you.
Outlander! I believe you have something of ours, Outlander.
Give him the book back.
No, if they have it, one of ours will die for Carousel.
The provider awakes!
Haha, your side doesn't have its book, fat ass. That means someone on your side is sacrificed tonight. Butters, your turn.
Oh, I'm gonna be sacrificed to the provider. I'm here for you, provider, but take me.
Is that what happened to the adults here? You lied to the police and said they molested you? My God, they were your parents. They are your providers, not some statue. And they're not off in some fantastical faraway land now. They're in prison, probably crying themselves to sleep, cold and lonely, and I'm sure missing you all very, very much. He won't take care of you. Your parents will. You all need to call the police and tell them you lied about the M-word.
He's right, dude. Things were a lot better with our parents around.
Things have gotten a lot worse in the 10 days since they've been gone.
Come on, you guys. Our parents are going to be back any minute.
Hey, here they come. Mom, Dad!
We're so sorry for the horrible sexual abuse over the years.
But you didn't do anything to me.
We did. We've come to terms with it through therapy and learned to admit it.
Oh, Stanley, I wish we could take back all the years of abuse, but we can't.
Kenny, we're sorry. Where is he?
Well, what are you kids gonna do now?
I don't know.
You guys want to go build a snow igloo?
Sure.
Snow igloos kick ass.
Okay, kids, let's take our seats. I'm assigning you all a book to read. Now, kids, this book is very controversial and has just been taken off the banned books list.
Oh, really? Sweet.
And it has some very risque parts and strong vulgar language.
Oh, man, I can't wait!
And tomorrow we'll discuss the...
No, no, come on, let's read it now!
Didn't the guy who shot John Lennon say it was because of this book?
Whoa, you're telling us this book is filthy, inappropriate, and made a guy shoot the king of hippies?
You will read it at home!
Did you get to any dirty parts yet?
No, it's still just some whiny, annoying teenager talking about how lame he is.
I don't get it, dude. What's so controversial about this? Motherfucker! I read the whole fucking thing! I kept thinking, all right, I guess the cool offensive stuff must be coming. And then I got to the last page, and I was all, the fuck is this?
Why the hell was this book banned?
Tricked us into reading a book by enticing us with promises of vulgarity. Why would anyone think this book is obscene or dangerous?
Kill John Lennon!
Kill John Lennon!
Kill John Lennon!
Hey, Dad, where does John Lennon live?
John Lennon's dead, Butters.
Aw, dang it.
We should write our own banned book. We could get a book banned way more than this one.
The Tale of...
Grody McDickinass.
Oh, that's good.
It was a warm spring morning.
The Tale of Scrody McBoogerballs?
It was a warm summer morning when Scrody McBoogerballs awoke to find his... Ew!
What? Oh! Oh my God! He then grabbed his dog... Walking out of his house, he spotted a bloody and pus-covered... No! Randy, you need to read this! This book! Our son and his friends wrote it! It's really good! I mean, it's disgusting! It's the most disgusting thing I've ever read, but the plot is amazing!
It was a warm summer morning when Scrody McBoogerballs awoke to find it... Ew, Sharon, gross! Oh, man. Oh, this...
But trust me, you gotta push through to the end. Please, you've got to listen to me.
She immediately stuck up his infected... That was all long ago in some brief lost spring. In that hour, the vag frogs begin, and the scent off Scrody's infected anus comes strongest. Oh, man. It's awesome. Sharon, it's the best book I've ever read.
What do we do, Randy? We can't support our son talking like this, but I mean...
People need to read this book, Sharon. This is Pulitzer Prize stuff.
Guys! We are totally fucked. The book is gone from my dresser drawer. My parents must have found it. So why are we all fucked? They'll think you wrote it up. Hey, I'm not taking the heat for this alone. We all wrote it. Well, dude, somebody has got to go down.
Oh, hey, fellas. I'm just watching the Kardashians.
Today, my sisters and I are going to have to wash something. It's going to blow.
Butters, listen, you are in big trouble. Yeah, you remember that book you wrote? Stan's mom found it. Dude, the book you left with us when you were sleepwalking last night.
I don't even remember that. But it all makes sense now. I must have channeled all my angst into dark writings in my sleep.
We've all read the book now, and it is very shocking to say the least.
Actually, it was all written by Butters.
Is that true?
Yeah, I barely even remember it.
We think that this is one of the best books we've ever read.
What?
We were actually so moved by your book, Butters, that we brought Mr. Needlebaum from Penguin Publishing to read it.
We would like to offer you a deal for first publishing rights to your brilliant novel.
We wrote that.
You already told the truth.
No, we really did write it. Tell him, Butters. I wrote that.
Oh, wow. Really amazing.
It is being called the most disgusting, foul, sickening book ever written. The Tale of Scrody McBoogerballs. So far, no one has been able to get through the first paragraph without vomiting. The book has already sold millions of copies worldwide and has been translated into 26 languages. The book is changing the literary world, and it is all thanks to Leopold Butters Stotch.
Butters, what the fuck do you think you're doing?
You know goddamn well you didn't write that book. You always take advantage of me. And after reading Catcher in the Rye, I've learned you're nothing but phonies. So the four of you can just suck on my wiener.
That inconsiderate jerk.
we meet the author of the book that has swept the nation. The book is full of disgusting words and acts, including Sarah Jessica Parker, who is mentioned 465 times.
Well, obviously, I just think it's wrong to make fun of anybody's physical appearance.
Uh-huh. And Matthew, how come a transvestite donkey witch is standing next to you, and why is it wearing a dress?
You must be pretty proud of your son.
And we also understand that your son is grounded, is that correct?
Yes, we did have to ground him for the language in the novel, of course, but we are very, very proud nonetheless.
But as soon as I'm not grounded anymore, I'm hoping to meet Kim Kardashian. I want to jump on her belly.
My favorite part of your novel was when Scrody McBoogerball slid his head up into the horse's... Sorry, was that chapter a slam on healthcare reform, as people have suggested?
Yeah, pretty much. I think so.
More and more of us are against this book every day. And for these reasons, we demand this book be banned from all schools, stores, and libraries.
That's just because you're too young to understand the underlying themes.
The author meant to be as gross as possible because it was funny.
Oh, so you're suggesting that the author just arbitrarily made fun of Sarah Jessica Parker for no reason?
Yes!
It's just because Sarah Jessica Parker is fucking ugly.
Miss Jessica Parker is a metaphor in the book for oppression felt by the lower class.
What? Dude, that is not in the book at all.
Oh, yeah. Then why does Sarah Jessica Parker's butt cheese end up in Scrody's milkshake?
The artist has announced that he is working on a second novel as a follow-up to his wildly successful bestseller. Can you give the public any idea what the new book is about?
Well, it's kind of about love and betrayal. I know what my readers want, and I'm going to deliver.
Butters, away from the window. You are being grounded.
Sorry, Dad. I was just being the voice of a generation.
I can't believe they won't ban our book. All right, you guys. I know what we have to do. We've got to kill Sarah Jessica Parker. If somebody kills Sarah Jessica Parker, then they'll assume that somebody did it because of what was in the book.
Dude, we're not killing Sarah Jessica Parker.
We don't have to kill her. We can just help her get killed. Shut up, Cartman.
Kenny?
We only have to help her get killed, and then we totally get back at Butters.
Oh, cool.
Miss Jessica Parker, over here.
Well, the day has finally arrived. The eagerly awaited second novel hit the shelves this morning, and apparently bookstores are jammed.
The line stretches all the way around the block. They've brought trash bags and buckets to throw up in. Just a festive atmosphere here, Matt and Meredith.
We are going to have a reading of the first five chapters of the book here live in our studio. Take it away, Morgan Freeman.
The Poop That Took a Pee. Chapter 1. Douglas had to poop. His butt was all stinky because he had to poop so badly. There was a gross woman named Rebecca. Douglas walked up to her and said, "I need to poop." "Okay," Rebecca replied. Douglas squatted down and went poop. The poop sat there on Rebecca's boobs, looking like a wiener. Chapter 2.
See any hunters yet?
No, no.
Just hang out right there.
Guys, stop! We don't have to do this! Butters wrote a second book!
So, dude, if Butters wrote a second book, then everyone's gonna know he couldn't have written the first one!
Oh, dude, sweet!
Why are we here? Douglas cried, as poop came out his wiener. It was wiener poop.
The pee-pee got on the woman's leg, and she screamed.
And so when the pee got mixed with the poop, it smelled like a butt.
Oh, dude, this is even lamer than we thought.
Are you reading this, Marcia? What do you think?
So far, I think it's incredible.
I agree. It wasn't as edgy, but it's like he's gone back to his roots.
You can't be serious. You people like this?
Some of the imagery is unbelievable.
A woman pooping out her boobs is not good imagery.
You must be a pro-life nut, huh?
What are you talking about? This book is as pro-life as it gets.
God damn it! Will you people stop reading into stuff that isn't there?
Kill the phonies. Kill the phonies.
Today, my sisters and I are going to shop for underwear.
Our nation is still reeling from the tragic deaths of the Kardashians. Immediately after reading The Poop That Took a Pee, it's all over. The Kardashians wiped out. All because one little prick had to go and write a book.
Leopold Stotch, I hope they bury you!
They're saying they're gonna ban both your books now, completely.
You think I care about that? My writing got the most beautiful woman in the world killed. I loved her.
It'll be all right. Listen, we've all learned that people look for meaning in books.
Yeah, dude, that's why we all need to avoid books and stick to television.
Thanks, fellas. I think I can get over this.
That's good, Butters, because we need to tell you something. You were sleepwalking again and dressed Sarah Jessica Parker up in a moose suit. You left her in the forest and she got shot by a hunter.
I got her killed too? Well, at least she was ugly.
Why do people talk on their phone like that? Holding the cell phone out like this and talking on speakerphone. You're not that important.
It's the worst pain of my entire life. And my friends were all like, dude, Cartman, we need you to keep playing defense. In the end, though, they really needed me to play, so I just played through the pain, you know what I'm saying?
But you totally started crying and quit the game. Take that shit off speakerphone.
Yeah, it's that kid Cal again. Stop listening to my conversation, Cal.
Yeah.
Dude, Toby, are you over at Lawrence's? You're what? What'd you say?
Me and Toby are ditching school.
Did you guys read 1984? I saw the puppet show version at Casa Bonita. A big rally to tell the government to stay out of our private lives. I seriously feel like I'm being spied on right now. Hang on, I'm going to make a video blog for my Stop Listening to Me website. There's going to be a big rally to tell the government to stop gathering information on us. You guys gonna update your blogs too? Okay, we'll put Toby back on the phone. You gotta start Googling everyone the directions to the rally site. Bro, you gotta email Dex about the rally and see if he'll bring petition forms.
Will you please take your rally conversation somewhere else?
That is the last straw, Cal! Just so you know, we might have an NSA agent right here at our SKU. The government is watching everything you do. They say it's to keep us safe.
But what price is safety, Cal?
The government watches everything we do?
There is no doubt the government is tracking me. I went to Amazon to see if they had Grand Theft Auto 5. You might also be interested in the Blu-ray for Star Trek. How did they know that unless the government is keeping tabs on me? I'm gonna get a job at the NSA. If I'm gonna infiltrate the NSA and get all their secrets out to the public, then I'm gonna need something better than Twitter.
You haven't seen the Alec Baldwin commercial?
Hello, I'm Alec Baldwin. But sometimes I accidentally tweet things that are homophobic. That's when I realized it wasn't me that was homophobic. It was my thumbs. But I know that everyone in America still wants to hear everything I have to say. It's called Shitter.
I'm at a Yankees game right now. People who take their cats on planes should be shot.
Don't let your social media slow down your need to communicate with the world.
Just finished my Shitter commercial. Time to go find a pussy sandwich.
I'm about ready to go to the NSA undercover. You can follow me on my Shitter account. Wait, shh. Kyle is here and I'm pretty sure he's trying to listen in. Don't know if you've heard, but the government is actually able to monitor all our emails and Twitter accounts.
You're okay with everything you think going up on the internet.
How many people are odd shitter?
Me and Alec Baldwin. I'm here to apply for the NSA job.
This man says he has an interview for a job, sir.
That's quite all right. The NSA needs all the help it can get. Welcome to the NSA main office.
Hey, Joe. Got a 24-year-old male in Albuquerque. He just emailed his wife and asked if she could go to the store after work. All right, keep an eye on him. Let me know if anything changes. If you think you got the stomach for this, then we could definitely use your help, young man. He just put on his Twitter account that he hates America and wants to blow up the Lincoln Memorial.
The chief asked me to join him as he went to question the possible suspect. Hopefully, the NSA has no idea of my secret intentions.
Say, what right does the government have reading my private emails anyway?
See, there's a lot of people out there who think like you. That is until a plane flies into a couple towers and a little girl loses her life. You won't care who's checking your Twitter account then.
I never thought of it that way.
I've infiltrated the NSA and gained their trust.
I just hope that I'm not found out as a whistleblower before I'm able to expose their entire operation.
You must have a pretty big file on Eric Cartman.
Yeah, we tracked him for a little bit, but Central Computer designated his status as fat and unimportant.
Trust me, he's not fat and unimportant. Excuse me, there's a very important threat to national security. We need to change Eric Cartman's status. Eric Cartman is the NSA's worst nightmare. The Central Computer is wrong. You need to change his status.
There's 300 million people out there. How do you think we're able to really know who's doing what?
Dude.
How we know who's sleeping and who's awake. How we know that...
I am Eric Cartman! This is all being broadcast live on my Twitter Zeppelin and on Alec Baldwin's new television show, Via Shitter!
Your secret is out, NSA. And now that everyone knows what you're doing to Santa, you can kiss your program goodbye!
Now everyone knows the truth, and everyone's gonna think I'm super cool. I infiltrated the NSA, and I thought everyone would be super pissed off at what I exposed about the government, but nobody cares! Nobody cares that Santa Claus is hooked up to a big, horrible machine! Now I'm a whistleblower against my country, and I'm gonna have to hide out in Russia!
How about I make you some hot tea with lemon and codeine?
I just want hot tea and codeine, no lemon!
Okay, hon.
Meanwhile...
The government is watching everything you do!
The government watches everything we do? Hey, government. Thanks for watching over me and doing everything you do. And please watch over Mommy and Daddy and even old Eric Cartman. I'd really like to get a puppy for Christmas this year.
Ned Government. Oh my God. Oh my God, they saw me. Maybe they didn't see me. No. No, they saw me. They see everything. Oh God. Here we go. I yelled at a midget. I was watching MTV and this little person was singing a song. So I yelled, "Hey, get off the TV, you effing midget!" I saw this picture of Jennifer Lawrence in a magazine. I cut the picture out of the magazine while no one was looking. I took the picture home with me and I cut Jennifer Lawrence's mouth out with scissors and then I put my wiener through the hole. How can I atone for it? I already said the Pledge of Allegiance 50 times and I watch America's Got Talent twice.
Why not 1,000 living in Americas?
Yes, I will. Oh, thank you. I will. Living in America.
Hello, sir. We from Jehovah's Witness. We believe, sir, that many people interpret the Bible as wrong. I was once like you. I know not what to believe, but then I let my provider Jehovah into my heart.
Oh, my goodness. Your little cartoon has a girl on fire. Well, you shouldn't be handing out drawings like this, ma'am. Well, don't you know that the government is watching you? When was the last time you went to your local DMV? Gotta go to the DMV. It's incredible. Just going to the DMV and letting go of all my wrongdoings filled me with a joy I had felt nowhere else. This'll tell you most of what you need to know about the DMV. But just go. Your government is watching you, and your government wants you to be happy. How would you like to know the truth? We're just going through the neighborhood and seeing if you've accepted the government into your heart. You see, Craig, once I came clean with the government, I no longer had anything to hide. Have you read any DMV literature? Well, there's a lot of interesting stuff in here, Craig.
Your local DMV is funded by your tax dollars to be efficient and proficient.
Well, we believe that he means the government loves you.
Yes, sir. See, I used to be like you. I go around sending the nasty emails, sending nasty tags, putting nasty pictures on my nasty Facebook. So all that live forever up in what they call the cloud. Because we all live forever in the cloud.
And that's when I masturbated to Game of Thrones.
What the? Why do these people keep coming here? Next, please.
Congratulations, brother.
I feel really good.
Those people over there seem like they're having fun.
Now let's all pledge allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag.
This is the DMV. There will be no joy here.
I'll put a stop to this.
How would you like to know the truth? Just let the government into your heart.
I have to go to Russia and live with the commie dwarves.
There's a place where you can start over.
I can be forgiven for everything bad I've ever done? And then all I have to do is go back to this place every time I do something wrong and admit it and I'm forgiven again?
That's right.
That's pretty cool.
We got a new member today! Eric Cartman, do you love your country? Hallelujah!
Yeah!
You want us to kick him out of here, Lair?
No. Perhaps we here at the DMV can start changing as well. We can offer them comfort and hope. The DMV can be a place where people come to get things off their chest. Be told that they're worth something in this world. Don't you see what this could lead to?
The DMV was shut down today after rampant allegations of sex with young boys. With the DMV shut down, Americans have been asked to confess all wrongdoings at their nearest post office.
Hello, family!
Randy, what is all this?
I did it! We're rich now.
Finally.
We are going into business of Blockbuster Video. Last week I saw it was up for sale. We have the entire business! Come on, you guys want to see it? It's a new beginning for us.
I don't want to go in there.
You got your sci-fi, comedies, buddy flicks, chick flicks. Well, what do you think?
You should try to get it on that ancient civilization show so that people can see how cultures used to live.
The average person still wants to rent movies they can hold in their hands. How many copies of Meet the Fockers do we have in stock, Shelly?
6.
That should be good.
You go get it.
Hey, you kids looking to rent some DVDs?
Ah!
Ha ha, nobody rents movies anymore. Fucking pricks. Hello, welcome to Blockbuster. Can I help you find something?
Yeah.
Emily, let's go rent a movie at Blockbuster.
You can be a spooky ghost all you want. It wasn't a stupid idea to buy this place. Streaming movies is not for everyone. Everyone just wants to prove that Randy's going crazy. Well, don't mind Randy, he's just losing his mind.
I think something might be wrong with Dad.
You think?
Yeah, it's awesome. Thanks, Mom.
Stan's about to go out with his friends.
Everyone rents scary movies on Halloween.
Randy, let him go trick-or-treating.
This is the night we turn it all around.
Renting DVDs is more ancient than Madonna's boobs. I can't go trick-or-treating.
Stan can't come,
but he's fucking Captain America!
Dude, you can't miss Halloween. I have an idea.
Trick-or-treat!
Look, honey, it's Iron Man, Captain America, Thor, and Bruce Valanche.
I'm not Bruce Valanche!
Oh, right, you're supposed to be the incredible Chaz Bono.
Just give us some fucking candy!
How are people supposed to get that I'm the Hulk when Captain America is on freaking FaceTime?
Trick-or-treat!
It's the Avengers! And Honey Boo Boo! Kids, come see the green Honey Boo Boo costume!
Check it out! We gotta stop him!
What say we take this scumbag down?
Cartman, smash!
You told me these things were full of money! I thought everyone would be renting spooky movies!
Oh, crap, there's a bunch of them. Holy shit, they shot this guy!
Fuck this, let's bail!
You let them get away!
Hey, we caught one of them. Who were your friends?
We didn't see anything, I promise. This is my best friends I've had. No! Their names are Bruce, Tony, and Kurt.
Get rid of them.
No! I won't say anything, I promise! Please, just let me go!
End of the line.
No!
Thanks for walking me home.
What's the matter?
Somebody dumped a... It's a little boy! Are you okay?
Oh, hello?
It's okay. Try and stay calm.
You have to get me to my friends. They aren't safe.
These guys took our friend.
They've murdered over a dozen people trying to get the cash from red boxes.
There's a kid over at the hospital saying he saw everything.
They said they were heading to the big party at the community center. Sir, you've got to cancel the Monster Mash.
We can't cancel the Monster Mash. It's Halloween night.
We're going to have to send one of you into the party in disguise.
Oh, wow. Nice costume, Stan.
Shh. Don't say my name, Butters.
Ah! Sorry, I can't see a thing in here.
Wow, Gangnam Style. I wish I'd have thought of that. Stan? Daddy wants to have a little talk, Stan. What are you doing, Shelly?
Nothing, Dad. Go back to killing the family.
Stan? Stanny boy, I'm coming! Who are you people?
Hey, I can't see.
You think I'm crazy for buying Blockbuster? Look at the people watching movies on their Xbox!
We got the son of a bitch.
Wasn't that Peterson in there?
Shh.
I'm coming!
I spoke with the insurance company. They said we can get some of our money back. Not all of it, but some. You want to come home?
No.
You want to just sit here a little more and be frozen?
Yeah.
You want me to bring you some McDonald's?
Okay.
Good morning, children. Mr. Garrison is away today. I am your substitute teacher, Mr. Weiland. Let's see. Eric Cartman?
Here.
Kenny McCormick?
Here.
Dude, what the hell was that? Dude, you know when you're laughing so hard that the milk comes out your nose? Oh, man. You have to be drinking milk for that to happen. Not with me, man.
Here's what we're going to do today. I've been told that one of your classmates has been ill for several days, Kyle Bruflovsky. Well, I've been told that in Mr. Garrison's absence, our activity for the day is to make a get-well card for Kyle.
Okay.
Hey, watch it.
Hey, what are you doing? Now that's a get-well card.
Kyle, Stan and his mother came over to visit you.
Hello, sweetie.
Kyle?
Well, the kids at school made you a card, Kyle. Look.
Butters, go on.
Well, all right then. We're so sorry you're not feeling well. We hope you're better soon. Everybody misses you, and though we hate to cause a fuss, we'd like to say get well soon and please don't die on us.
Dude, you really are sick, huh?
I don't know.
I don't know what to do, Sharon. They want to have him go into surgery.
There's a brand new shop in town that sells holistic medicines and all-natural foods. It's run by this fascinating woman named Miss Information. Why don't we at least take Kyle down there and see what she has to say?
Okay, I'll get our coats.
You see, the reasons our bodies fail is because of toxins. But all your son needs is a toxin-flushing diet of lemon juice and cayenne pepper.
You don't need surgery after all.
Excuse me, but what do these toxins look like?
Don't be a smartass, Stanley.
Oh, thanks for coming, Ms. Information. Kyle seems to be getting worse.
Oh, I don't agree. He seems much better. Those are the toxins flushing out of his system. Now, don't be fooled. As Kyle's body sheds itself more and more of all the toxins, he will appear to be getting worse. But actually, he is getting better.
Oh, Stanley. Your little friend Kyle needs a kidney transplant, or he will die.
I'll give Kyle my kidney, even if it hurts a whole lot. I don't care.
That's very brave, Stan, but there's only one person in South Park with the same blood type as Kyle.
Oh, shit. Give me the space cruiser, Kenny. I broke your space cruiser, Kenny.
Well, some more of your little friends are here to play with you.
Okay, man.
And don't get too close to Kyle. He looks like he might have the AIDS.
Kyle's in trouble, Cartman. I can see him getting worse right before my eyes. There might be a way that you can save his life. Will you donate one of your kidneys to Kyle? You only need one, fat boy. I need about $10 million. I suggest you start looking for that money quickly. Kyle doesn't seem to have much time. Tick tock, tick tock. Okay, where were we, Kenny? Oh yeah. Quick, Captain, we must destroy the Gungeon on Cluster 5. Give me the space cruiser. Give it, Kenny. Yeah.
Oh, look, everyone. These are our two resident Native Americans.
I'd like to buy some stars.
Oh yeah. This is a dream catcher.
These here are Cherokee hair tampons.
Look, I know that you all think the Earth and its natural healing powers can cure Kyle, but the doctor at the hospital told me it can't.
Everything's going to be fine, Stan. We're bringing Kyle in tomorrow to see the Native Americans personally.
Isn't it possible that these Indians don't know what they're talking about?
Enough, Stanley!
Nobody wants to listen, Kenny. I don't know what else to do. I'm not just gonna stand here and watch my friend die. Kenny, go round up all the kids in town who want to help Kyle. Kyle's gonna live! This is it?
Well, Claude was gonna come too, but he said his mom was making tacos for dinner, and Claude likes tacos a whole lot. Well, where are we going?
We're gonna go take Cartman's kidney. Uh-oh, Cartman's pig. Good pig. Shh, it's okay. Oh, no!
Oh, well, we're busted.
Shut up, Fluffy! No way! Kidney blocker 2000? What? Oh, Stan and Butters, trying to take my kidney, are you? You suck, Cartman! God damn it, don't you care that Kyle is gonna die? I do care! Look how much! Look how much I care.
There's nothing more I can do, Kenny. I've tried everything to save Kyle.
Look out!
I'll never see Kyle again.
Okay, here he is.
No, I mean, he looked really sick, man. You should take him to, like, a doctor. Being in touch with the Earth has nothing to do with dying, man.
And besides, we're not actually Native Americans. I mean, I'm more like a Mexican.
Hey, we never said we're Native Americans, man. Misinformation said that.
Kill her!
That's funny.
So now can we take Kyle to the hospital?
Yes, of course, but we don't have a kidney donor.
That's all right. If you'll all help, I think I have a plan. That son of a bitch! Okay, asshole, give me back my kidney! It's mine! Not yours, mine!
Right, here.
Why, hello there, Eric.
My asshole friend Stan took my kidney, and I need it put back in. Please, it doesn't belong to Kyle. It belongs to me. Thank you. Hey, what's going on? Kyle's all better, Cartman, thanks to you, huh? It was all a trick. Your mama did the kidney blocker, and then we put ketchup in your bed so you'd think we took your kidney.
Yes, but it was all just a trick to get you to come in and sign this release.
I am so pissed off! I said I'm gonna kill you guys! Careful, Cartman, you might pop your stitches.
What the?
Oh, good, you got the crappy kidney.
Meanwhile,
the school board believes that you should take a hiatus from teaching. Indefinitely. Frankly, Mr. Garrison, it isn't even your educational record that we're most concerned about. It's your somewhat substantial police record.
All we're saying is perhaps you should take a little hiatus from teaching until this little child molestation thing dies down a bit.
Very well. I guess I'm not a teacher anymore. I suppose you'll be wanting my badge and gun.
Mr. Garrison, most teachers do not carry a gun.
I don't know what I'm going to do, Mackie. Teaching is all I know.
Okay, well, maybe you need to view this as a chance to do something you've always wanted to do.
I've always wanted to write a novel. Yes, that's it.
I am going to write the great American romance novel.
Out on the balcony, when Reginald kissed Diana's lips, her knees went weak. Slowly, he pulled her top down, exposing her soft, unyielding breasts. Oh yeah, now this is getting good. It was a fantastic penis that seemed as strong as a horse's leg, yet as delicate as a flower wrapped in silk. Diana's nipples...
Oh, writer's block, writer's block. I'm stuck. Oh well, maybe that's enough writing for tonight, Mr. Hat.
Chapter 18.
Oh yeah, Mr. Hat, hot lesbo scene coming up.
And as Rebecca's naked body lay before her, Diana couldn't help but feel aroused. It felt good, like a penis. A soft but sturdy penis that felt warm to the touch. It was as if she were in a redwood forest of penises. They presented themselves, tall and mighty all around her with...
Mr. Hat, what the hell are you doing? Oh, Mr. Hat.
Yes, Mr. Garrison, we did read your book.
Well, what did you think?
Well, frankly, Mr. Garrison, we don't know if the Hurricane Romance label is appropriate for you. No, this is what we in the book publishing business like to call gay. Really, really gay.
Well, women want to read about ding-dongs. You think women care about the details of female anatomy? Hell no! Women want to read about big, powerful schlongs. Look, I've seen women read these things. They skim along until they get to the part about the penis. That's what they want, so that's what I'm giving them. Oh, here's everybody.
Hey, Mr. Garrison, where have you been?
Boys, I have an announcement to make. I'm not gonna be your teacher anymore. I've become a best-selling author, and Kyle, I want you to have a signed copy as a get-well present.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah!
Man, you guys are good.
Oh, Stan and Kyle bought a new video game. They're just little plastic controllers. You hit the colored buttons, and it makes the guitar track on the gameplay. If they spent half the time learning a real instrument as they do playing that game, who knows what they could accomplish?
So you boys like this music, huh? Well, you kids want to see something really cool? Once I rose above the noise and confusion. I can actually play a lot of these songs on a real guitar.
That's gay, Mr. Marsh.
Yeah, that's stupid, Dad.
But this is real.
Real guitars are for old people.
We want to watch Dad and Kyle play.
All right, let's try to score 60,000 points this time.
Don't you cry no more.
I heard you just broke 100,000 points on Guitar Hero, and I'd like to be your manager.
Dude, Kyle, this guy wants to be our manager!
Scoring 100,000 points is impressive, but I think with the right label behind you, you boys could make 1,000,000 points.
But I hear the voices say, they all really have to.
Well, what do you think?
I like it. That's these boys playing?
No, that's Kansas. But these boys scored 100,000 points to it.
All right, we'll sign them to a 1-year deal.
Cool!
Swing it!
You rock!
Nice rehearsal, boys. That was real cool, kids. I have no doubt you can break 1,000,000. But, as for your friend, well, I think he's holding you back. Look, you score a lot higher than him. There's no question who the better one is. Find a partner for you who can really help you max your score. You're gonna love this kid, Stan. Stan Marsh, this is Thad Jarvis.
Sup?
He can play Guitar Hero acoustically. Show him what you can do. Pretty damn good, huh?
I thought you were sick. This is, Thad Jarvis.
Sup?
What's going on, Stan? Mr. Kincaid thinks I should play with Thad for a while. What makes you so high and mighty? Don't put this all on me, Kyle. You were the one that's been blowing off playing after midnight. Look, the point is, I'm never gonna break 1,000,000 points playing with you. I guess I didn't realize it was just about the points. Let's just do this, all right? My manager and producer set up this live thing at the video arcade where I'm supposed to break 1,000,000 in front of everybody, and I'm I'm stressing out.
Yeah, Guitar Hero can be pretty stressful. You should just buy another game to kind of ease the stress. Heroin Hero?
And there's no score? No crowds?
No, man. All you do is run through the pretty forest and chase a big dragon.
Chase me! Come on! This way!
Dude, this is awesome. Did you practice last night? No, you know what? Screw this! I'm not playing this song. Why did you pick this stupid song? We're changing the song to Cheap Trick.
No way. I hate that bubblegum crap.
We play the music I want to play.
Yeah? Well, how about this one? I quit. I quit.
Stan, what is the matter with you? What is this? Are you playing Heroin Hero?
Just a little.
No. Nobody plays Heroin Hero a little.
I know, but it mellows me out, okay?
Now you're gonna have to break a million points and unlock Superstardom solo.
Catch me. Come on. Catch me. What's wrong? Follow me.
Stan, you got... Oh, my God. Get up, Stan. Wake up. You're going on in 10 minutes. Everybody's coming to see you. You gotta pull it together. Pull it together, goddammit.
Yeah, I'm
at it. Go, Stan.
All right, Stan, you got it, man. Here. Come on, Stan. You got it.
God damn it, he's a mess. What are you doing?
Come on, guys. Let's get out of here.
You had it all and you blew it. Listen to that video crowd. They hate you. So, did you break a million yet?
I'm done with that stupid game.
Once you start playing Guitar Hero, you can't stop till you reach the top.
I just want to find something else to play. Just want a nice, simple driving game. How's that?
It's the song that two local fourth grade boys scored 100,000 points to on Guitar Hero.
Once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse of me.
Game is still set up at my house, and maybe we could go try playing it again over there.
I can play here all I want. I even get free frescas. I don't need you anymore.
I'd just like to play with you again, for the fun of it.
I've been close to a million a few times by myself.
Then let's go, dude. All right, dude, let's do this. What the hell?
Oh.
Come on. Come on. You almost got me. Catch me. Come on.
Hang on, I almost caught the dragon.
No, me and Kyle are gonna play Guitar Hero. You don't ever catch the dragon, Dad.
No! I am your father! Put it back on!
Fellas! Fellas! They're about to break a million on the door here and unlock Super Stardom! They did it!
Oh, my sweet Jesus!
Congratulations! You are bags!
That's it? God damn it! Butters, you want to play me next?
Okay, but I get to be the one that betrays you after the sex and drugs party.
It's me and Kenny versus you two assholes. Oh, dude, what's with all the homeless people? Could you move a little, please? Ah, dude, he smells like Kenny's house.
These people have nowhere to go. They don't have food or shelter. We have to do something.
I know exactly what we should do. The ramp ready? Yeah, it's all set.
Oh!
Yes! I jumped over the homeless! That was a sweet idea, Kyle.
God damn it, that wasn't my idea!
Hi. I've been saving up for a new Xbox game, but I think you could use the money a lot more than I could. It's $20.
Got any more?
I thought that was a lot.
Spare any change?
You're welcome. Oh, crap. Dude, what are all these homeless people doing in front of your house?
Spare any change, sir?
I don't get it.
I kind of gave a homeless guy $20 last night.
Kyle, what were you thinking? I can't possibly jump this many homeless people. I could jump 2 homeless people, but asking me to jump this many is asking me to risk my life, Kyle.
There are homeless sprouting up all over town. What are we supposed to do?
We could turn the homeless into tires. We could use them on our cars.
Like it.
That's like recycling. Excuse me. I don't know why more homeless people are showing up in town, but I do know. If we give them anything, There could be more.
Spare some change? Got any change?
Can you spare some change?
Change? Ah! Change! Spare some change?
Leave me alone! I don't have any change!
All right, God bless you, sir.
Oh, now I feel bad! Here! Ah!
Spare some change?
I just gave you change!
Change?
Spare some change!
Change!
I don't have any change!
Change!
Oh, stay away!
Randy, what happened?
I don't have any change!
South Park has become overrun with the homeless. Many people are trapped throughout the town.
Help! Help us!
In the meantime, South Park citizens are being advised to stay indoors.
Spare some change.
No, I don't have any change.
Change!
I don't have any change. I don't have any...
You see what you did, Cal? Come on, we have to try and help our stupid parents.
Change!
They're everywhere!
Change!
What are you boys doing? Get in! Change. Come on, let's go!
Change.
What the hell are you doing outside?
Our parents are stuck on top of a building in town.
You aren't getting into town. It's completely overrun with these things. Just stick with me, kids.
Over here. Jump down, go. Oh, God, it really smells like Kenny's house down here.
No sign of anybody else.
I'm gonna make a break for it.
You'll never get through all those homeless people.
If I can make it through them, maybe I can catch the bus to Fairplay.
Spare some change?
Spare some change?
Got some change? Change, sir?
Change. Don't have any change.
Change!
God bless. Damn it! All right, you want change? Here! There! There's some change!
Wait, now I don't have any change left for the bus.
Change, sir?
Can I have just a little change for the bus, please? Anybody have some change?
God bless.
Change! Change?
He's become one of them.
Are you the head of homeless studies? We think this may be our friend's fault. He gave one of the homeless $20 yesterday.
Get in here!
There's a bunch of people trapped in the middle of town, surrounded by homeless people. I think I know what to do. I'll try to jump all those homeless and get to the people on that roof. If you can get me a skateboard, I'll try to jump that homeless crowd and save those people.
You barely made it over one, fat ass!
Cartman jumping more homeless people isn't going to solve anything right now.
I don't think you quite understand how the homeless function. Perhaps you should come downstairs. I've dissected several homeless to see what makes them tick. They're almost identical to us in every way, except for one. The homeless can survive solely on change. They need it in order to keep them moving.
Is that some spare change?
Now watch.
Spare some change?
It has already completely forgotten that I've given it change. It just wants more change. I've learned that the nearby city of Evergreen had a homeless problem just before we did, and they were able to stop it.
The front door was open. Can I borrow some change?
Oh my God, they're coming in. Quick, kids, get out of here. You can fit.
What about you?
Get to Evergreen and find out how they got rid of the homeless.
Hello? I'm sorry, I just really need some change for the bus.
Sorry to take the easy way out.
Hello? Please, let us in.
Find another place to hide, Steve.
We've nowhere else to go. One woman here is pregnant. Let us in. For God's sake, they're coming.
Change.
No. No, I'm sorry. We don't have any change.
This isn't happening.
All right, fine.
Could you spare some change, sir?
Ah! No, damn it. We're out of Pop-Tarts. We're gonna starve.
No, wait. There's still a box over here.
Those are cherry. Yeah.
I got a signal.
Call the fire department.
I'm calling my wife. Mary, what's going on out there? They what? No. But how can that be? We didn't even... What happened, Glenn?
Because of all the homeless in South Park, property values have plummeted. I had two liens against my house, and so the bank is foreclosing. I don't have a home anymore.
He's homeless now.
How can they just take away my house? Where am I supposed to put all my things? I'll need to pay for storage. Can I borrow some money to put my stuff in storage? Each one of you just put in a little change? Change?
What the hell happened here?
Just march your butts right back out of our town.
We just came to ask a question.
Get out of here before you die. Cartman? The kid who jumped 30 homeless people on a skateboard?
30 was hard enough.
Oh, God!
wasn't 30. It was 1.
Kyle, knock it off.
Please, we just want you to tell us how you got rid of the homeless in your town.
The homeless first started arriving in Evergreen about 3 months ago. They fed off of our change to the point that they could actually start renting apartments. People living in the house right next door to you could be homeless and you wouldn't even know! That's when I started suspecting that my own wife, who I had been living with for 20 years, was actually homeless. So I had to burn her. After she died, I vowed I wouldn't let the homeless destroy our town.
You didn't solve your homeless problem. You just sent all your homeless to South Park.
That's right, yes.
It wasn't because I gave that guy $20.
But then you didn't solve the problem. You just moved it.
Right.
Genius! You sons of genius! I wasn't homeless, you stinky asshole!
Our parents are just as stupid as these people. Our town is going to end up just like this.
Come on, I have an idea. We're going to save our parents before they all kill each other.
Let's hope to crash this works.
California love.
California! Super cool to the homeless. Lots of rich people giving change to the homeless.
They're listening. Let's go! Honestly, I don't know what you see in this, Kyle.
Yeah, nice one, Clyde!
Clyde, get up here! Hurry! What is that? We've been through this countless times, Clyde!
Okay, Bob.
Put it down! Put it down! Thank you!
Dude, that sucks, Clyde. Look, could you guys just not say anything about this at school, please?
Clyde! Clyde! What have I told you about pissing on the seat? Cartman, it was actually really lame.
I know, right?
Clyde! There you are! Clyde Donovan, you come home this instant!
Mom, I'm in class.
I was trying to get ready for work and the toilet seat was up again! If I had sat down, I would have gotten toilet water all over my vagina! You are coming home right now, Clyde, and you are putting the toilet seat down where it belongs.
Clyde had to get up in the middle of class and follow his mom home to put the toilet seat down.
I know, fat ass, I was there. It's not that funny. Don't you feel just a little bad for Clyde?
Uh-uh.
They're trying to save Clyde's mom. Clyde left the toilet seat up again.
When she fell into the toilet, she also made it flush.
Can't we disconnect the toilet?
Yes, we'll have to, but when we do that, we'll rip out her organs.
I want you to know I don't blame you for this. Just please put the seat down from now on. Let me go. Let me go. Do it. Do it.
Bob?
It isn't a woman's responsibility to see that the seat is down. It's a man's responsibility to put it down.
Yeah, that's right.
Putting the toilet seat down isn't that hard. So is it too much to ask women to just look?
Please have some respect. There's a little boy here who has lost his mother because he couldn't put the toilet seat down when he was done peeing.
Hello, Mom, get the door!
Hello, ma'am. We're the Toilet Safety Administration.
Can we come in?
Sure.
Hey, that's my bathroom!
Yeah. We're gonna have to completely redo this, ma'am. We'll go ahead and install your safety belt.
The toilet's to be fitted with a safety harness so that nobody can fall in. This is for your safety. A woman died, you know.
So we were just wondering if we could sue somebody.
You can always sue somebody. Here we go. Inventor of the toilet. John Harrington. Died 1692.
So then we can't sue him?
Here at Hoffman and Turk, we specialize in suing the dead.
A suance can be very expensive.
How much do you have?
Clyde got $3,000 from his mom's life insurance.
That's exactly how much a suance costs.
Wow, that's weird.
Hey, officer.
Oh, come on, don't give me a ticket.
Gotta wear the safety belt or you could fall in.
You can pay this by mail or appear in court on that date.
Yeah, thanks, asshole.
Stupid Toilet Safety Administration! You can't even take a crap at IHOP without a 40-minute line!
This is inhumane.
Shut up! Taking a dump today, ma'am?
I just needs to check inside your asshole.
Okay, I'm done. I don't need you wiping my ass for me.
Yes, you're a big boy, aren't you, sir?
I'm a big boy. I took a big boy poop.
Put your coffee in the plastic tray, please, sir.
Yeah.
I just needs to check your asshole. Asshole clear?
Hey, what's that thing? Oh, you people have me on camera now?
It's time for us to stand together and say, we want the government out of our bathroom! All we have to do is bolt our toilet seats down.
If the seat can't raise up, the men will just pee all over it.
How about we agree to that if men will agree that they will always sit down to urinate?
What about us loggers? Hard-working men who like to stand up after they've taken a poo and then turn around and cut their poo in half with their urine.
Yeah, I think we gotta just live with the TSA.
Yeah.
Security breach.
Shock and outrage ensued after an unknown terrorist managed to get through TSA security with a gun. The head TSA chief of operations had this to say.
Shit.
Why have we given up freedom if terrorists can take a hostage in a bathroom with a baby and a gun on the toilet? It is time for a sue-off.
Yeah!
Sir Thomas Harrington, your extreme negligence hath cost taxpayers millions!
You will be sued, Spirit!
Appear before this court, Harrington!
Clive, this lawyer is a fraud. You can't sue the dead, Clyde. Don't try and blame Mommy's death on anything but your failure to do something I asked you time and time again to do!
Now hold on just a second! It's not anyone's fault! You can't sue me! You're all using my toilet invention the wrong way! You're supposed to be facing this way! Why would I design it so that when you're finished taking a Sir Harrington, you have to stand up, turn around, and look down right at your Harrington to flush?
Oh.
It's all like, Clyde, what have I told you, Clyde, you asshole? Dude, it was a riot!
That's not what I said.
I know you've had a tough week, Clyde, but at least your mom didn't die for nothing. Clyde?
Clyde, you there? Hello?
Yeah, well, you want to do something? Sorry, Eric. I haven't written a good joke in over a week. All right, well, maybe I can help you. Oh, well, sure. Doesn't your mom have something more substantial to eat? You can check the freezer. There might be some frozen fish sticks or something. Wait a minute. Fish sticks. Fish dicks. What, dude, you got something? Say, Eric, do you like fish sticks? Yeah? Well, what are you, Eric? A gay fish? Oh, dude, that's funny as shit! Say, Clyde, do you like fish sticks?
Yes.
What are you, Clyde? A gay fish?
You said you like fish sticks in your mouth. That makes you a gay fish!
Token, got a question for you. You like putting fish sticks in your mouth?
Yes.
What are you, a gay fish?
Buying fish sticks, I see. What are you, Peterson, a gay fish?
So apparently more and more Americans are eating fish sticks. Have you seen this? Have you read about this? What is everybody, a gay fish?
It is quite possibly the funniest joke ever conceived, and its origin is unknown. In fact, the only person who appears to not get the joke is rapper Kanye West, who becomes furious when people use the joke on him.
If I was a homosexual or a fish, I would know. I'm a genius, all right? I'm the most talented musician in the world.
And you like fish sticks?
Yes.
You're a gay fish?
All right, that does it. I'm gonna kick your motherfucking ass. But I'm going to prove, once and for all, I am not a fish.
He does not have gills.
So I can't be a fish. Now, are there any questions?
Do you like fish dicks?
Love them.
You're a gay fish.
No, I'm not. Ah! Yeah, viva la Mexico.
Where did you have time to come up with this classic joke?
So I was just all like, hey, Pepito, you like fish sticks? And then it just occurred to me. I was like, oh, man, you must be gay fish, huh? And that's just how I came up with it, mi amigos.
Give it up for Kanye West!
Yo, whoa, whoa, what the hell?
Gay fish, gay!
Yo, fuck this noise, yo! Why is everyone calling me a gay fish?
If you don't get it, you don't get it.
What do you mean I don't get it, House? I'm a genius.
You see, fish dicks is a play on words.
I don't need anyone telling me play on words. I'm a motherfucking genius.
Yo, Kanye. Kanye, we found him, money.
Oh, fuck, man. Kanye West. Oh, shit, man. Okay, look, it wasn't me. I didn't really start the fish dick thing, all right?
Now, explain it to me. Why do people think I'm a gay fish?
Because you like fish dicks, man. Come on, man. You're a gay fish, man.
Meanwhile...
Dude, that's our joke on national television! Jimmy, I've been thinking. We've got to patent the fish sticks joke. We should be getting compensated.
We should just be happy that the joke is so popular and made a lot of people laugh.
Dude, fuck that! I'm gonna talk to a lawyer so we get what's coming to us.
Exactly what part of the fish sticks joke did Cartman write?
Well, I mean, he was in the room.
Then just give him half.
What? Jimmy, if Cartman didn't write the joke, then definitely don't sign any patent papers with him.
Consider yourself lucky he's only asking for half.
Carlos Mencia is taking credit for our joke! Now look, I got a lawyer to drop some patent papers.
I really don't think I want to sign that very much. I basically wrote the thing, and you just kind of ate chips.
We decided that day to write together, don't you remember? Let's write some jokes together.
Here's some fish dicks, guys. Hope you like fish dicks.
What does she think we are, gay fish? We had an agreement, Jimmy. Hey, Kyle, can I talk to you for a second? It's just... I don't know what to do about Jimmy. Because we really both did come up with it.
Yes, I believe that you believe you helped write that joke.
No, I definitely helped write the joke.
We have with us the true creators of the fish sticks joke.
Hi, Ellen. You guys like fish sticks? Thank you. No, really. Thank you.
How did you come up with this incredible joke?
Truth of the matter is that there's never really been a team like us before. I mean, let's be perfectly honest, a lot of people wouldn't work with someone who's disabled. Working with crippled people is really important.
And are you crying, Jimmy?
Yes, ma'am. Anyway, what was really important for us as a team, Ellen, was to make sure that everyone knew that we came up with this joke.
I see. And did you know that Carlos Mencia was found dead in his house this morning with fish sticks stuffed down his open neck hole?
So check it out. We've got offers from Vandecamps and Gorton's Fisherman to do commercials.
Eric, there's something I really need to know. How do you live with yourself?
How do you take credit for something you didn't do? I had just as much to do with the fish sticks joke as you did.
Tie up these motherfuckers! Why did you start these rumors about me?
Well, we were just talking about ideas for jokes and then...
Oh, so now it's we, huh, Jimmy? We both came up with it together. You want to know how it happened?
I'm trying to write jokes, but I'm not as funny as you, so it's tough.
Now, let's see.
Eric Cartman, you are handsome and not even remotely fat.
Thanks. So what I'm thinking is, do you like fish sticks in your mouth? What are you, a gay fish? There! You gotta let Jimmy go. It's all my fault.
You won't even admit it was just me, knowing you're gonna die?
I realize now you can't help believing you created the entire joke. Some people just have egos that are so out of whack that no matter what people tell them, they can't accept the truth of who they are. Thanks, Eric, for being so understanding.
But they weren't making fun of me. They were trying to help me.
I know what I have to do. It's time for me to stop running. I'm going home!
Come on.
I've been so lonely, girl, with other creatures like me, and now I got my wish. Cause I know that I'm a gay fish. I'm a fish, yeah. Going on a gay fish. Fish, I'm feeling like a whore, cause I wasn't being true, even though everyone fish, gay fish, gay fish, yo, motherfucking gay fish, gay fish. I'm a fish.
Well, Dad, it was really great seeing you.
I got a present for my grandson. It's time for you to have something expensive.
Isn't that beautiful, Stan?
Grandpa, how much did you spend on that?
$6,000.
Dad, you shouldn't be spending your retirement money on frivolous things. You should be saving it for when you die. That's our money.
Nice bolo tie, Stan.
Look, it was a gift from my grandpa, okay? And it cost a lot of money.
Dude, it's fucking gay as fuck.
I know. Why don't you take it to one of those pawn places? Every two blocks you see a guy with a sign that says cash for gold and jewelry.
It's 14 karat gold. I'll give you $15.
That cost my grandpa $6,000.
I'd have to send it to a smelter, have it all smelted down for the gold. Probably could make a $10 profit.
Dude, this guy's trying to rook us. We can go someplace else. Yeah, I'm not getting taken advantage of.
These are real diamonds, right?
Yeah, dude, you can test them.
$8.
Welcome to Taco Bell.
I want to see how much you'll give me for this gold and turquoise diamond bolo.
14 karat gold, catch you. I guess I can give you a 6-layer burrito for it.
My grandpa paid $6,000 for something barely worth anything. How does something like this happen?
You want to get in on these deals, call now. Look at these stunning earrings. These earrings normally go for $6 million. $320. I believe we have a sale. Do we have a sale? Who am I speaking with?
My name is Vivian.
At that price, you practically stole them from us. Ouch!
How did they get away with that?
This is a new time.
For centuries, alchemists have tried to come up with the formula to make gold. Guys with cash for gold signs gets you people's unwanted crappy jewelry divided by demented old people equals gold.
Somebody's about to get this $20,000 topaz and copper ring.
I'm buying it for my grandson, Billy.
Grandpa?
How about that, folks? That is Brazilian emerald. Not wasting your time here. You can't afford not to buy this one. You don't have a lot of time left.
Grandpa?
Don't you think your sister would like that?
She doesn't like jewelry, Grandpa.
She's just a baby, after all.
She's not a baby, Grandpa. She's 13.
Right. Right, boy. Billy, did I ever tell you I used to have a border collie named Patches? I loved that dog. I can't remember what she looked like, Billy.
Don't worry, Grandpa. I'm gonna take care of this.
And that's it. We've just sold this bracelet to Miss Marcia Tubbs. You there, Marcia?
I'm lost walking on the freeway.
We got a caller already on this one.
What you do is sort of unjustifiable. You're the definition of evil. I just read that the day shopping networks make most of their money is on the day seniors pick up Social Security checks. Your only chance to right the wrongs you've done and repay all the elderly people whose lives you've destroyed is to kill yourself. I'm not joking. Do it.
Okay, next item. This is 200 carat Brazilian emerald and plasticine ring. $8 billion. Tell you what, I'm gonna take it down a little. We're gonna drop that price to $75.95. Butters, looks like, did we sell it? Yep.
Hello?
Yes, you just bought this lovely 200 carat ring. Can I ask you something, Mrs. Appleby? Do you like fucking little boys? You just got an $8 billion ring for $75.95. You fucked me good, Mrs. Appleby. Congratulations, ma'am.
Thank you. I thought it'd be a lovely gift for my granddaughter, Jessica.
Okay, thanks for shopping with us. Bye. Man, that's good acting. I should get an award.
Do you have any idea what it would feel like to start losing your memories?
All we do is smelter down what we get from the cash for gold places.
Whoever smelt it, dealt it.
We aren't the ones who denied you what your jewelry was really worth. The Hindu saying is actually, whoever denied it, supplied it.
You are the scums of the earth. And you kick back in your fat cat mansions making billions.
We aren't making that much, fellas.
The old Hindu saying is, whoever smelt it, dealt it.
Nuh-uh. It's whoever denied it, supplied it.
It's all made in India, where those Hindu rhymes come from.
That's right. Whoever made the rhyme did the crime.
Hello? I can't get enough of people's unwanted crappy jewelry to keep up, so I'd like to buy some of yours. I don't know. I guess I'll take that ring there.
Oh, you make so good choice! You take advantage of my low prices! You like a fucker Asian lady?
What'd you say? Wait a minute. How much do you pay for this stuff? Okay, quit the act. I'm not fucking you and you know it.
No, you fuck me!
Fuck you! You see, I'm looking to cut out the middleman. Motherfuckers! How dare you take advantage of those less fortunate? You guys stole my formula, then tried to fuck me... Butters!
Sorry!
And then tried to fuck me out of your business!
Somebody is at the head of all this, and somebody needs to pay. No, not a diamond and gold necklace! Yeah. Actually, this might kind of work. So then, we went to India, which is pretty cool, I guess.
Sounds like you had a fun weekend.
I wanted to give you something.
Oh, old Patches. There's that slobbering happy face. That means a lot. That bolo tie you're wearing, it's fucking gay as fuck.
And we got... Oh, do we have a buyer on the line? Hello?
What are you waiting for? He was right. Do it.
You're too scared to do it, aren't you? You don't have the balls. You got lady balls.
I got a gun right here. What do you think about that?
Pull the trigger.
I've got more friends than Kyle. I've got more friends than Kyle. How the hell do I only have 37 friends? Are you guys doing that stupid Facebook stuff again? Why are you guys in here wasting your time? We're supposed to be out playing video games. Stan, we know it's hard to get started. We made you your own Facebook page. No, I told you guys I don't want to be on Facebook. Yeah, but now you can be friends with all of us. I'm not collecting friends and I'm not building any farms. I don't want to get sucked into this. You can just be like Kip Jordy. He's got no Facebook friends and he's had a profile for more than 6 months. Everyone should have one Facebook friend. You guys are retarded. I'm playing Xbox.
Hey, Stan, I saw that you have a Facebook page now. Well, so are you going to add me as a friend?
No, Dad, I really don't want to get more into it.
So I'm not your friend then?
Dad, it's just a stupid click of a button that takes 2 seconds.
All right, fine. Just to be clear, you and I are not friends.
All right, Dad, I'll add you.
Oh, cool, okay.
Think I'll add some more pigs. Oh, maybe I should put in another field of corn there. Nice. 29? No, I have 30 friends. Hey, what the hell is... Oh, no! Oh, shit!
Am I a joke to you? I just want to know, is that all I am? A big joke?
You do have a Facebook page, Stan!
Oh, goddammit, no, I just got that because
Kyle... Yeah, well, I saw your page, Stan. Relationship status? Single? You like being single, Stan? So that you can use Facebook to find other girls?
All right, I'll add you as a friend. I'm sorry.
And you better change your relationship status to in a relationship.
Stan, why won't you be friends with Grandma?
Dad, I just really don't want to pay attention to this
Grandma
thing.
Grandma is in the hospital, and you won't even be friends with her.
All right, Dad, I'll add Grandma as a friend. Dude, fuck Facebook, seriously. What the hell is this? Hello, fellow Facebookers. I'm here to do one thing. Get you more friends. Kyle Broflovsky's stock is plummeting. He had 55 friends just 2 days ago. He's down to just 11 this morning. You're going to want to dump Kyle, and if at all possible, add Clyde Donovan. Why? Clyde has a birthday coming up, and his mom is taking everyone to Casa Bonita. That's all the time I have for today. Remember, update that profile and steer clear of Cal. Dude, what's the matter?
I don't have any friends.
Ever since I became friends with that Kip Drordry kid, a bunch of my other friends have started ignoring me. I know that I should just dump Kip as a friend, but that's such a terrible thing to do, and I really need a friend right now.
Okay, dude, I'm here for you.
Okay, so then get on Facebook and fertilize my crops?
No.
But my farm hasn't expanded in 3 days!
I do not want to start doing all the farming stuff, too!
Please!
Okay, it says I'm at your farm.
Okay, so now just click on the little soil button.
Okay, it says you and I are now very good friends.
We're very good friends! We're very good friends, Stan! I think you look cute in your bunny costume? What is that supposed to mean? That's what Susan92 wrote on your Facebook wall! You give girls pictures of you in bunny outfits? Fuck you!
Susan92 is a friend of my grandma's and she's 92 years old!
Oh, hey, Stan! I commented on your status, but I haven't heard back from you. Could you give me a poke sometime soon?
How come you ignored my friend request?
I don't know you.
...845,000 friends.
Stan, Grandma said she poked you and you haven't sent a poke back. Stan, poke your grandma!
No! Screw this, you know what? Delete profile!
Delete your profile, are you sure? Yes, no, yes!
Are you totally sure? Yes, yes! God damn it, yes! Delete, please! Dad?
All right, get moving, profile.
Tom Davis says hello to Linda Green's profile.
Excuse me, my name is...
Ignore.
God damn it, I got sucked into Facebook. Excuse me, could you please tell me what the hell's going on?
No, you aren't my friend. Would you like to be my friend?
Okay, I'll be your friend.
Confirm.
Here are some pictures of my dog, and here he is in some silly outfits.
Ah!
Move it, profile.
They're taking him to the gaming arena.
Looks like I'm gonna be down a friend.
You are about to face each other in combat!
Yahtzee?
I'm gonna count five, my $5.
Yahtzee.
You were not supposed to survive the game of Yahtzee!
I don't even want to be here! God damn it, my Facebook profile has taken on a life of its own!
Your profile is one of the most powerful in all of Facebook. You cannot stop it now.
I just can't seem to get my friend numbers to go up. That's why I came to you. But I just don't know how to make totally new friends on the internet.
It's not as hard as it sounds, Cal. Have you ever heard of chat roulette? We just set ourselves up on webcam, and then the computer will randomly put us with one of the 50,000 people online also doing chat roulette. All right, let's see who our first chat partner is.
Ah, that's some dude jacking off!
We'll just click to the next person. There we go. Hello?
That's just a guy's penis, too!
This is seriously an amazing gathering place where people from all over the world can share their thoughts and ideas. Ah, here's a guy. Hey, dude, how's it going? This is my friend Kyle. He's looking for some new friends.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, he's taking out his penis.
Dude, screw this! I don't want to see anymore!
If you want to find some quality friends, you gotta wade through all the dicks first.
That's it, Cartman. I'm out of here.
Wait, Kyle! Here's a nice little Jewish kid.
Hello? I was starting to think this was nothing but dudes jacking off.
Do you want to be Facebook friends?
Well, sure. If you'll come and visit my farm.
Heck yeah, I'll visit your farm. You should check mine out, too.
Okay, I fed the pigs.
Oh, wow, cool. That Jewish kid put up a sign on my farm. Stan?
You're an asshole, Kyle. What's the one thing I told you? That I didn't want to get sucked into Facebook. This is all your fault. I found your farm on Facebook so you can help me deal with this bullshit. You gotta go check my profile status.
It says that you are currently hosting an online chat party for all your friends.
Son of a bitch.
Jesus Christ.
Randy Marsh is at work right now. Work is boring. Randy Marsh is at work right now. Work is boring.
Grandma Marsh would like to be friends with Kevin Donahue.
Kevin Donahue accepts Grandma Marsh's friendship.
Susan 92 has pictures of Stan in a bunny costume.
Kyle Broflovsky is amazed Isaiah is also a Facebook friend of Stan's.
Isaiah Zordon is deleting Kyle Broflovsky as a friend. User saw you are friends with Kip Doherty, who only has one friend.
No, I'm not really friends with him.
Ignore.
That does it.
Where is profile Stan Marsh?
Right here.
Damn it, I should have deleted you a long time ago.
The fact of the matter is, I'm up and running now with almost a million friends. I don't need you anymore.
Friends shouldn't be some kind of commodity for a person's status.
Let's end this once and for all. Large flesh already! You don't have a chance in here, user! You're pathetic little
Yahtzee!
Kippy!
Yahtzee!
You have zero friends.
Oh, thank God.
My computer says we're not friends anymore?
Fuck off, Dad. I'm sorry, Kip, but I really can't be your friend anymore. This is the hardest thing I've ever had to do.